That's why.
We do now.
Now we have sound on YouTube and I guess Facebook Live as well.
Beard. So nobody heard what we just said.
Man, we've had an awesome show to this point. If you missed it, I'm sorry. You missed probably the best part of the show.
Sorry. Softball Shirley.
That was my fault.
Softball Shirley not hitting the program button.
Hilarious. Let's go to the phones. Oh, sorry. We can't.
Technically, that's your responsibility.
Chandler putting it off on Shirley.
Shirley putting it off on herself and then blaming me. Hilarious.
Classic.
Well, Chandler. You know, I do what I can.
What'd you say you were doing Saturday?
This past Saturday, I was doing getting ready for a Whiteville Wolfpack broadcast.
I completely forgot about that. Where is our game highlights?
Well, unfortunately, they do not record the broadcast, but I asked the producer the other day, I said, can you do it, you know, from here on out? And he said yes. So we should have be able to get some snippets of my calls. Not really that much excitement the other day. 36-0 was the final score there. Whiteville versus West Columbus. So really not really any calls of the game there. I did have a pick that I got very excited for early in the football game, but yeah, but in the future we will be able to record the broadcast and hopefully we will be able to have some highlights for you.
So are you more who do you model your play-by-play after?
Really,
are you Eric Collins?
No, I'm really no. I mean, maybe I need to, like, next time there's a pick six, go, oh yeah, pick six, Nick Bellamy.
You know that you're Eric Collins and your what's the Titans guy, Mike Keith?
Oh, Mike Keith.
They're kind of close together.
Yeah, especially on the oh yeah.
If you do a you know just like a player. You take everything from every coach that's ever coached you.
Just kind of form it into one.
You should take, you know, things from different broadcasters. You could do an, oh, yeah, touchdown, Whiteville, Eric Collins, Mike Keith mashup.
Oh, yeah! touchdown! Wolfpack!
Yeah, think about that for Saturday. All right, or Friday. When's your next game?
Friday at 7 o'clock.
Friday night. All right. Speaking of high school football, three and a half hours from now, we've got high school football right here on Pirate Radio. It is game day. I have not seen anything otherwise. Have you, Shirley, regarding weather or anything? Is this game still set to go?
As far as I know, I have not seen anything that indicates that the game is not going to be played.
Yeah, so I guess we'll have some football for you.
That has not come across the Shirley Rhodes news desk.
I will set up the show, and then we'll find out what has been going on in the sports world. As basically, all you need to know right now is the Patriots have signed everybody.
Basically,
that's pretty much the NFL news. Coming up at 3:15 in about 10 minutes. Maybe we should do it at 3:16 in honor of 3:16 Day and Stone Cold Steve Austin. Billy Weaver going to join us, the sports director at WITN. We got a lot to talk about with Weave. Coming up at 4 o'clock, we'll talk to Tommy Eason. Not a great day if you are a baseball coach, but Tommy Eason and his ball club have been able to get some games in with some nice weather here of late. We'll talk some Pitt Community College baseball and find out what's going on with the Bulldogs. After that, Stephen Igo, Hoist the Colors, will join us on what was supposed to be the first day of spring football practice. The weather said otherwise, so they'll get going later on in the week. Stephen Igo will be here in hour two on into hour three, and then at 5:30 we will talk lines, odds, maybe a little NBA as well with Ariel Epstein, formerly of WCTI 12. Now she is everywhere. And we'll talk to Ariel coming up in hour three. The prop queen will join us to get you ready for the NCAA tournament. So that's what's on the show today, plus your thoughts and comments. You can chime in on Facebook Live or Twitter. And Shirley and Chandler, let's go to your respective news desks and find out what's going on today in the world of sports.
Who wants to go first? You want me to go first?
I only have some NFL news. I can knock that out of the way if you don't mind.
Okay, go ahead.
So you're right. Just say I'll go first.
I'll go first.
All right.
Cam Newton, they're starting to build around him. Yesterday they were able to sign Jonnu Smith from the Titans. Today, another tight end move going to New England as they sign Hunter Henry from the Los Angeles Chargers. So I believe the top two tight ends in the free agency this year are heading to New England. So Cam has got two big-time targets at the tight end position.
So they're not Travis Kelce or George Kittle, but in that second tier of tight ends, we're talking Jonnu Smith, Hunter Henry.
Hunter Henry was on a lot of people's fantasy teams this year. I remember going to tiebreakers, and a lot of people there were talking about or cheering when Hunter Henry was scored. So he was utilized a lot in fantasy football this year, I know. But, yeah, so Cam Newton not only has a really good tight end in Jonnu Smith now. I mean, I wouldn't say he's all fantastic, but now he has another guy in Hunter Henry as well.
Well, those are the main weapons, right? Better than any of their receivers
right
at the moment,
yeah,
I would say. All right, what else?
Now, I mean, I'm just hoping that now they don't get Curtis Samuel. That would really hurt, break my heart.
Saw a tweet where Washington was potentially looking into adding Curtis Samuel.
Wow.
Speaking of Washington, news last night.
Wow, that should be on my news desk. But
should be the top story today. Another team for Ryan Fitzpatrick.
And unfortunately, it's your team.
Yeah. I tweeted back in February. I want to go ahead and get it out of the way. Before it happens, and I have to talk about it, I don't want Ryan Fitzpatrick.
And guess what you got?
A big old hairy man named Ryan Fitzpatrick.
Wow.
And I was wondering how, when I saw that news pop up on my phone, I was thinking to myself, I was like, I wonder how Clip feels about this.
Yeah.
Because I didn't want him as my starting quarterback.
Here's my thing. In past years, I'd be pretty pumped up for Fitzpatrick because he's so much fun to watch. He is a very likable guy. He's easy to root for. And he makes games fun because of the chances he takes and the crazy plays he can make sometimes, not just with his arm, but even with his legs at times. But we are in a position right now where we have a playoff defense, and if we're not going to have a good quarterback, Washington should have a boring quarterback that does not make mistakes, that does not lose the game for you. And I just feel like Fitzpatrick is too much of a wild card. He throws too many interceptions, takes too many risks. I will like to see him go downfield to Terry McLaurin, which we did not do a lot last year. But I just don't think he is the type of quarterback Washington needs with the team they're building and with the defense they have right now.
Curtis Samuel, you mentioned him about potentially Washington kind of having interest in him. What's the point of having someone like Curtis Samuel when you have the quarterback room that you have right now with Ryan Fitzpatrick, Taylor Heineke, and Kyle Allen?
I mean, let's not completely poo-poo Fitzpatrick. He does throw down, but Samuel's a downfield guy, right?
Who's that?
Curtis Samuel.
Yes.
Now, he can stretch the field. My problem is he throws way too many interceptions. He has the 48th most interceptions all time. I put this out on Twitter last night. I know it's not a fair comparison to compare anybody to Tom Brady, but it's more about attempts and interceptions. So Fitzpatrick has 22 less interceptions than Tom Brady. Tom Brady has thrown 5,574 more passes than Ryan Fitzpatrick.
Wow.
So, you know, almost 5,000 passes, over 5,000 passes, and Fitzpatrick almost has as many interceptions as Tom Brady.
One more note in the NFL before I hand it off to Shirley. Another big target in free agency, someone that I was hoping that the Carolina Panthers would get, former Seahawk Shaquille Griffin has signed a 3-year, $44.5 million contract to go to the AFC South and be with the Jacksonville Jaguars.
Jaguars. I saw
wait, who was that again?
Shaquille Griffin.
Yeah, I had that on there, yeah.
I don't think this is news. I think this was just Chris Johnson tweeting. But he said, I like Fournette to the Seahawks. Was that just him like saying I would like that fit, or has that happened?
I haven't seen anything
about it. Okay. No. I think it was just Chris Johnson saying I would like that fit.
I was seeing a tweet earlier today that it looks like playoff Lenny might be coming back to Tampa Bay. That's
they're re-signing everybody. Really, they got Gronk back for another year.
Gronk said
$10 million for the next year.
Gronk says that he's going to be a 1-year contract guy for the rest
of the way out.
Yeah.
All right.
I don't blame him. I mean, he's got enough championships. He's made enough money in the NFL. He really has no reason to stay other than wanting to play. So, yeah, just make it a year-to-year deal and, you know, get as much money as you possibly can. I mean, $10 million for a year, that ain't a bad gig.
Got a lot of people just walking in and out. Most recently, Mike Mullis, who popped in. He did the Grandpa Simpson gif.
Mully.
He pops in.
Slides right back out.
And pops right back out. All right, what else is on the news desk today?
Let's see. Jaden Gardner received All-District first-team honors today from the National Association of Basketball Coaches. So congratulations to him. We got a football update for ECU football. We got a couple of dates set already. Earlier today, it was announced that ECU and South Florida will play on Thursday night, October 28th. And that game will be in an ESPN primetime slot, although we do not have a kickoff time. We just know it's going to be in a primetime slot. So we know that. And we also know that ECU will take on Temple on Saturday, November 6th. So those are the two games we've got so far that have been confirmed through the conference and through ESPN.
So, Shirley, when the schedules came out, that was like at ECUPirates.com.
That was like
two Thursday games.
Yeah,
but they both
Thursday or Saturday.
Yeah, read the fine print. Thursday or Saturday. So one of those will be Thursday,
and it will be on ESPN primetime
against South Florida. The Temple game Saturday. So,
yes. So is that the crew with Pat McAfee?
Thursday night ESPN. Yeah, I guess so.
Yeah,
sweet.
So we'll.
Wow.
You know anything? Oh, what?
That'll be Pat McAfee and Mike Houston's first face-off since he called him a coward.
Oh, wow.
Oh.
How about that?
Oh, yeah. That'll be interesting.
That'll be a big storyline heading into that game.
Because I'm sure that Mike Houston would love to have a conversation with Mr. McAfee.
By the way, Shirley, nice hat. That hat was sent here by our buddy Steve Hill. And Shirley has gotten me a Hornets hat, got Chandler a Nationals hat. She is the hat mom. And I like that.
We just
got
to keep our hat game strong. That's all I'm doing. Just making sure that we set the bar high.
I'm flat brim life. I like the fitted hats. This is more of a curved bill adjustable hat,
which is my speed.
It
more
is
than
a
yours.
Really good looking hat. Like I love the logo. It is the Corpus Christi Hooks.
Yep.
And
which, by the way, I believe Kyle Roller used to play for the Corpus Christi Hooks.
Let's see who they are an affiliate of. But I have re-gifted that hat to Shirley and courtesy of Steve Hill.
They are now an
Astros affiliate, AA affiliate, the Corpus Christi Hooks.
And if you look up Kyle Roller, I'm almost positive when he finally decided to stop playing baseball, he had been playing with the Hooks for a while.
In honor of Kyle Roller. All right, well, we'll have to see.
Who reminds me, Josh Moylan reminds me a lot of Kyle Roller.
Yes, he is in the long line of big, stocky first baseman for ECU. All right, any other news and notes, Charlie?
Yes, let's see, where am I on the list? Also, a little closer to home, the North Carolina Basketball Coaches Association voted Baby T, Farmville Central's Taquavion Smith, the player of the year for the state of North Carolina. So congratulations to him. Farmville Central's Amaya Joyner was voted All-State second team along with North Pitt's. I'm going to probably mispronounce her name, so I apologize ahead of time. Zamaria Jones. I hope I pronounced that correctly. But those two were also placed on that same Coaches Association voting slot, so congratulations to them. You were talking about NFL notes earlier today. The Broncos did pick up the option on Von Miller's contract, so we can get Steve and Igo's opinion on that.
Uh-huh.
And a couple of basketball notes. Six NCAA men's tournament referees were sent home after one of them tested positive for COVID. So this is going to be an ongoing situation with the tournament getting underway on, if you count the first four, then that would be, Thursday? And then you have the actual tournament beginning. I call it the tournament beginning on Friday. But that's going to be an issue we're going to have to keep a close eye on. And Richard Pitino got fired yesterday and then got hired yesterday, as New Mexico hired him less than a day after he got fired at Minnesota. So he didn't go very long being unemployed. So, but that's all I've got for the Shirley Rose News Desk.
I also have a tidbit. The T.H. Conley game for tonight, per Troy D., is a go.
Okay.
He said that he has had a confirmation that they will play regardless of weather conditions in New Bern, and it will be right here on Pirate Radio.
Well, let's get it on. Got some football coming up. Just saw that Grant Paulson, who covers Washington, said they had Albert Breer on from NFL Network, and he was discussing Washington's addition of Fitzpatrick and said they see themselves as a real contender right now. They wanted to lock in a guy that could win, that they could win with right now. Speaking of Ryan Fitzpatrick, you know, Ryan Fitzpatrick career playoff numbers?
Does he have any?
Hold on. Say. I'm giving them to you right now.
None.
Zero.
I'm still going over them all.
Okay.
There are none.
Passing yards? Rushing yards?
None.
Games?
Games?
He has none.
Minutes?
Appearances? None. Zero. Zero, 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 and a whole bunch of zeros.
He's been in the league for 47 years.
He's played for 12, like,
and not
the
been
league.
To
they
the playoffs.
Awful.
And they want to win right now, and they bring in Ryan Fitzpatrick.
And they want a guy to win playoff games he doesn't play in the playoffs.
Yeah, but you gotta, he's a good kid.
You gotta start
give
somewhere.
The kid a chance.
He's a good backup quarterback. That's what he is. He's a
fun.
Journeyman.
He's a sideshow. He has a big beard. He's smart. He went to Harvard. He's fun. He throws interceptions and wears DeSean Jackson's necklace.
But he doesn't win games.
He did in Miami.
I mean,
but they didn't do any. I mean, but you can't really count that because that's just more regular season than anything. But I mean,
Shirley, go to we'll pull it up when Weaver joins us. We got to take a timeout. Trent Dilfer said it best. You cannot lose games in the NFL and still win. One of the greatest lines of all time. We'll pull that up when we return.
Oh, by the way, a quick ECU baseball note for tomorrow. That game has been officially sold out. All the tickets are gone.
All right.
For ECU, UNC Wilmington tomorrow night at 6 o'clock.
NWO sold out. We will take a time out, come back. Billy Weaver joins us. Maybe I bet Billy likes this move. We'll talk to him about it. We'll see. I hadn't talked to him yet. We'll get his fresh reaction to Ryan Fitzpatrick to Washington. Talk a little NASCAR, NCAA tournament, Pirate Sports, everything in between. We're back with you on Pirate Radio Live after this.
Waiting just outside your front door. Service is back, so you're connected to destinations worldwide through flights from American Airlines. Plan your next trip. Book your flights today at flypgv.com or aa.com.
Whether you're flying for business or for pleasure, enjoy the friendly convenience of flying from your local airport to get you where you're going and then home again safely. For your next trip, remember, American Airlines is back at PGV. Book today at aa.com. Pitt Greenville Airport, where the Pirates fly.
White Claw Hard Seltzer, a wave of refreshment. Crafted using our unique Brew Pure process. Made pure. Nothing tastes like White Claw Hard Seltzer.
White Claw Hard Seltzer, available in 5 fruit flavors, 2 grams of carbs, gluten-free, and 100 calories. Find it at WhiteClaw.com. White Claw Hard Seltzer. Nothing tastes quite like it. Proudly distributed by Coastal Beverage. Please drink responsibly.
Oh, great. It's 30 degrees in here.
No one's coming out this late.
I'm on firewood.
Dad! I'll put hot coals in our socks for bedtime.
Mom!
I'm from Delcor Heating, Cooling, and Plumbing. Got an email about your heat being out?
That was me. I sent it from my phone.
I think your socks are on fire.
Ah! Delcor responds to heating emergencies 24 hours a day. Go to DelcorInc.com or call 252-321-8868. Get a new train system with special financing for 60 months, subject to credit approval. It's hard to stop a train. Offer expires 3/31/21.
In studio today with Dr. Shondell Jones from Kinetic Physical Therapy. Dr. Jones, you guys can help people with any aches or pains.
Yep, we sure can. As it's getting warmer, we know more people are outside wanting to be more active, and we know spring sports are in play as well. And so if you've got a knee or ankle injury, whether it's just a strain or a sprain, you know, we've got specialists there to treat the weekend warrior and the athlete. For more information, visit us online at kptonline.com or call us at 364-2806.
Villa Verde Dos on Arlington Boulevard is excited to announce they're going to begin serving breakfast. To kick this off, they are doing a Breakfast for Heroes on Tuesday, March 16th, where all frontline workers get breakfast for free. 6 a.m. to 11 a.m. If you're in healthcare, police, EMT, firefighters, just present your badge and you get a free breakfast. Ordering only one bowl or one wrap per person. It's Breakfast for Heroes, going on Tuesday, March 16th, only at Villa Verde Dos on Arlington Boulevard.
Hey, Pirate Nation, this is proud ECU graduate and former baseball player Brandon Manning inviting you to join my team at Farm Bureau Insurance. Right now is a good time to review your coverage with a local trusted agent like me. I will make myself available before or after business hours, and my clients always have my cell phone number if they need anything. From home, auto, or life, give me a call today and let's talk about your insurance coverage and about the Pirates. Call 531-1812 and go Pirates!
National Signing Day is come and gone, but that doesn't mean the recruiting news cycle is stopping. In fact, the Pirates still have their sights set on top targets in the transfer portal and have already turned their attention to the 2022 class. HoistTheColors.net has the latest on EC recruiting from a football perspective, and we also cover basketball and baseball commitments like no others. Sign up now and get your first month for a single dollar to get the latest scoop on your favorite Pirate teams, along with in-depth baseball and spring football coverage in the months ahead. HoistTheColors.net.
With rates being historically low, now is the best time to buy or refinance your home. This is Talbot Green with Angel Oak Home Loans. Now is the time to take advantage of the opportunity to buy more home or refinance your current mortgage. The combination of our local team's experience and Angel Oak's wide offerings of products from standard conventional, government, and portfolio loans has something for most financial situations. For more information, call Talbot Green, Joanne Weir, or Wanda Hager at 751-2060.
NMLS 1719250 and 685- 842, Equal Housing Lender.
This is former ECU baseball player and mayor of Greenville, PJ Connolly, and you're listening to Pirate Radio, the voice of Pirate Nation.
You're listening to Hour 1 of Pirate Radio Live. This hour is brought to you by University PC Care, your local tech support experts for all your personal and business needs. Visit universitypccare.com to learn more today. Now, back to the show.
Welcome back. You've worked hard to start your business and are working even harder to make it successful, and that's why it's important to have a bank in your corner when you need them. As the business world throws you curveballs, Select Bank and Trust is here to be responsive to your needs. Select Bank's team of local bankers can make local decisions and cares about you, the customer. Get the business services that are right for your business today with Select Bank and Trust. Bank local, bank select. Now let's head back into Pirate Radio Live. Here's your host, Clip Brock.
All righty, hour one of Pirate Radio Live. Overheard Sterling there calling Weave, and sorry we're calling you a little late, Billy. I was ranting about Ryan Fitzpatrick. We will not. Thanks, Chandler, showing me a picture of Ryan Fitzpatrick in the Washington jersey. Billy, let's get your thoughts on it. Sorry to the non-Washington fans. We're going a little Washington heavy to start the show today, but got a lot more to talk about with Weave. Weave, what did you think of the news when you heard it last night?
Not a big fan. Seems like it's another one of those Daniel Snyder moves where he signs a guy that's 17, 18, 19, 20 years into their football career and expects them to produce at a high price.
It's got Jeff George written all over it. I will say Fitzpatrick is way more likable than Jeff George ever was. But my thing, Billy, is that Ryan Fitzpatrick would have been a lot of fun on the bad Washington teams we've had to sit through over the years, just to, because he is a fun player, he's easy to root for, but such a risk taker, and with the defense they have now, I just don't feel like he's the style of quarterback this team needs. I don't know. I'm not a, and he's gonna go off week one and have 370 yards, and everybody's gonna be like, hey, this is the real deal. He's done this a million times, folks. Don't buy into it. He's going to come back the next week and have three interceptions. But I don't know. We'll see what happens. Maybe it'll be fun, Weave, but I'm like you. I'm not really on board with it too much.
Hey, man, I agree with you 100% on that respect, because, look, if you look at the history of the NFL and teams that had outstanding defenses. And that's what the potential is in Washington, to have a team that is carried by your defense. We saw it last year, and those guys are young and only going to get better. You've got Hall of Famers, future Hall of Famers, I should say, that are on that defense, and especially on that defensive line with Chase Young. And the thing is, if you've got a defense that good, you need a quarterback that doesn't make mistakes, that doesn't go out there and turn the ball over a bunch of times, and an offense that turns the ball over and can't, you know, just manage the game. That defense doesn't need to be on the field all the time.
Yep.
That's how defenses like that get run down. That's how they get beat. If you can keep the defense off the field, you know, periodically to rest, they'll be successful. And that's the thing, is you can't have guys out there taking a lot of chances at the quarterback position. You know, and I always talk back about, you know, the Carolina Panthers. People around here, you know, that follow the Panthers and know what the Panthers are all about, remember when Jake Delhomme was there, and he was that type of quarterback. He was very serviceable. He was, you know, a good quarterback. He wasn't a Hall of Fame quarterback. He wasn't one of those guys that lit up the stat sheet, but they had an incredible defense, and they went to the Super Bowl behind that type of team. And that's what I think, you know, Washington needs right now. And I don't think, you know, Fitzpatrick is that kind of guy. Now, if you want to groom a guy like Taylor Heinicke and, you know, have Fitzpatrick in there to be that mentor, absolutely, I see. But $10 million for that, I just don't think it's a great sign and a deal for Washington.
The more I'm reading these Albert Breer quotes, he was on with Grant Paulson up in D.C. who covers Washington, the angrier I'm getting, because he says, this is Ron reaffirming to the guys on the roster that we are ready to win, end quote. Another one was, they see themselves as a real contender right now. They wanted to lock in a guy they could win with right now, end quote. Ryan Fitzpatrick has never been to the playoffs, Billy. Like,
no.
Never. And what is he winning? He is not winning anything. I don't know. Why are they trying to spin it this way? It makes me angry, but anyway.
When I hear that my team has signed a veteran quarterback and he's been in the league 17 years, the rest of that better say Tom Brady, Aaron Rodgers, Drew Brees.
Yeah.
Not Ryan Fitzpatrick.
Yeah.
I'm sorry. But if I'm going to have a quarterback that's been in the league 17 years, he better have a name behind him, and he better have had won Super Bowls. This guy's never even been to the playoffs. Come on.
Yeah. All right. Well, moving along. I tell you what, Bill Belichick did not like having a losing season last year, Billy. I was a little surprised they're bringing Cam back, but they are stocking him up with some weapons, bringing in a couple of tight ends, Jonnu Smith and Hunter Henry, the latest news today. So Belichick, usually you don't see the Pats too, you know, aggressive at the start of free agency, but man, they have been this year. They're trying to retool and try to get back to where they were, or at least some semblance of what they were before. We'll see what happens in year two with Cam in New England.
Well, you know why that's happening, is because in the past in New England, people were knocking down their door to come and play in New England. Bill Belichick's not the easiest coach to play for, bar none, and players will tell you that. So they weren't knocking down the door to come play for Belichick. They were coming to be a part of the Patriot way. And they knew if they came there, you know, most of those guys that came through free agency to the Patriots were taking less money to come there because they wanted to win Super Bowls. Not the case there anymore. So now the Patriots have to be aggressive in the free agent market, and they're actually, to be honest with you, sort of overpaying for some of these guys. But they feel, you know, for all the years that they've underpaid because guys have wanted to come there and win Super Bowls, that's not the case now. So now they're having to be aggressive in the free agent market and go out and pay for some of these guys and hope to rebuild it that way.
Billy Weaver joining us on the Fixed NC Live Line. NFL free agency in the news, March Madness in the news as well. We need to get you down here in the next couple of days so you can fill out a bracket and be in our bracket pool. So if you get a 15 minutes, stop by the studio and fill out a bracket, Weave. Have you looked at it yet? Have you filled one out yet? You got any upsets or surprises for us?
Well, I haven't filled one out yet. I have looked at it, and I've looked through some of the teams. How can you ignore Gonzaga? I think that's going to be the team that's atop everybody's list. If you don't have Gonzaga in the Final Four, I question whether or not you're serious about your bracket. How can you not have them in the Final Four? And, you know, they could be the first team since Indiana in 1976 to run the table and go undefeated and win a national championship. Is that going to happen? Who knows? But they are legit, and I think Mark Few's got his best team that he's ever had at Gonzaga, and that says a whole lot. So obviously they're at the top of the heap. I think Illinois, Michigan, those are teams you got to look at. You know, one of my favorite story of the NCAA tournament and the brackets now that I'm going to have to, like, really fight against myself not to pick them a bunch just because of the storyline and just because of what I think about it. Patrick Ewing at Georgetown, you know, he goes there and he takes over a storied program at Georgetown that, you know, from basically, you know, he played for John Thompson, who of course has passed away. And now he's the head coach there. He left the NBA to go there. They were a number 8 seed in the Big East tournament, and they go and win. And of course, all the drama and all the fun that happened with Patrick Ewing at Madison Square Garden. So that's a team that I'm kind of really pulling for and hope is a bracket buster.
I don't know if he was on the hot seat weave, but you know, he had not had too much success there. They were not going to make the tournament. They went on that run, and I'm like you, I got kind of swept up in the Hoya paranoia and, you know, playing at MSG and the, you know, like you said, the passing of John Thompson. I loved their run in the Big East tournament. I think it comes to an end in round one against Colorado, but no. I didn't think they would beat Creighton by 30 points either.
Yeah, that's true. I don't know. There's always that Cinderella, and if there's going to be one this year, that's one I'd like to see. You know, I don't know if that's going to happen or not, but who knows? There's a couple of teams with some interesting storylines in there, of course. And, you know, Rick Pitino, how about that back in the NCAA tournament? And one of only 3 coaches to have taken 5 different teams to the NCAA tournament, which is pretty cool.
I love the Pitino story where he's in Louisville, Kentucky, Providence, not in. His son got fired yesterday.
Yeah.
He's the guy in the movie, Billy, the villain, that he's slowly walking away as everything explodes behind him. You know, he comes out scot-free. You know, nice guys finish last. Good for Pitino. He's in there.
How about, you know what he reminds me of? Is he reminds me of a gangster.
Yeah.
He reminds me of an old-school New York gangster. Very slick dressing and all this stuff, but he's the Teflon Don.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
Nothing sticks to him, and wherever he goes, he manages to kind of, you know, find his way, you got to admire a guy.
The bodies are piling up around him, Billy, but not his. He's fine.
That's right.
Chandler pointed out, good eye by Chandler last week, we were watching Iona and Siena in their conference tournament, and he made the observation, Rick Pitino is the only guy he's seen this year wearing a suit as a coach. Because, you know, Billy, they've all gone to kind of the warm-ups and the kind of the low-key attire. Rick Pitino's still rocking the suit on the sideline.
Yeah, I mean, it's his trademark.
Yeah.
I mean, that's what was so much fun when, you know, East Carolina played Louisville back in the conference USA days, and Pitino would walk into Minji's Coliseum just looking Dapper Dan, and, you know, that's his thing, man. That's part of the allure of Rick Pitino. And, you know, to be completely honest with you, I'm sure he uses that as a recruiting tool, because these young guys, they like that swagger. They really do. And they like, you know, when coach walks out there in the, I don't know, you know, $1,500 Armani suit, the Italian shoes. It's a big deal for those guys. They kind of want to emulate them. So, hey, it's work for him for sure.
Yeah, even in his old age, young people still like Ric Flair, Billy, and that's because of the style and the swagger. And no matter the age. All right, we were supposed to be talking some football today, some ECU football, but spring football. Not getting underway, practice anyway, due to the weather. It was a nasty one earlier, and we're going to have to wait a little bit on that. But Mike Houston and the guys getting ready to take the field this week.
Yeah, and you know, I mean, I hate to beat a dead horse, but when is East Carolina ever going to get an indoor practice facility?
Yep.
If you've gone over to NC State and North Carolina and some of these ACC schools, and I've even seen, you know, you kind of troll around the internet from time to time, and you see some schools that you would not expect to have an indoor practice facility for football that do. I mean, where is East Carolina's? There's two things that you know is going to happen. One, it's going to rain in the spring around here, and two, it's going to rain in the fall around here because that's hurricane season. We get lots of rain in both the spring and the fall, and it, you know, I can remember Steve Logan griping and complaining and arguing, and I mean, seriously,
we're going back 25 years.
Absolutely, This is when I first got to this market back here. I've been here 22 years, and I remember first coming in here and Steve Logan on these rainy days or bad days for weather saying, you know, these other schools have got indoor practice facilities. He had screamed for an indoor practice facility for his entire tenure there, and it still hasn't happened. I just don't understand it. I don't get it. I know there's talk that maybe in the future, but I mean, it's definitely long overdue.
Yeah, no doubt about that. Billy Weaver joining us on the Fixed NC live line. ECU baseball back in action coming up on Wednesday, Weave, as the Pirates hit the road for UNCW. Another sweep over the weekend, this time against Charlotte. Tyler Feldman brought up the buffet to Cliff Godwin. The hitting, the pitching, and something I've continued to go back to, the defense of this team, Weave. I said it yesterday, you don't get excited to go to the ballpark to watch a baseball team play defense, but with ECU, I do. Agnos and Giles and even Connor Norby, who's known for his offensive prowess, is doing a great job. Their infield has been spectacular and just playing good fundamental baseball right now, and that pays off. They're a top 10 team right now, Billy.
Yeah, and top 10 in six, you know, very good major national polls, which don't get me started on that either. Why national polls for baseball? I just don't understand it. It every week or every time I do something on the air about ECU baseball, I struggle to, I guess I just kind of look at the ECU releases and say, okay, whatever they call themselves, number eight, number nine, you know, they're number seven, eight, or nine right now in one of the six polls. So are they the number seven team in the country? Are they the number nine seed in the country? And early, you remember in the preseason, they were ranked anywhere from, I don't know, maybe 18th to 30th?
To not ranked.
Something crazy?
Yeah.
You're right. I'm like, it's just a weird thing.
Billy, I like how you said, don't get me started, and then you just got yourself started.
I know. Now I'm going back to Steve Logan again, another Steve Loganism, because I remember whenever you would talk about the NCAA or anything like that, Steve Logan would always say, don't get me started. Billy, don't get me started on that. And he would talk about the NCAA and he'd get started. But yeah, East Carolina is playing really good baseball right now. And I tell you what, UNC Wilmington's going to be a tough one. They always are. It's a great rival game. They're 10-3 right now and coming off a sweep of App State. Poor App State. You know, they come to Greenville and get swept, and then they get swept by UNC Wilmington.
Yeah.
But anyway, you know, UNC Wilmington's playing very well right now. And here, 15 games into the season, East Carolina's 13-2 and looking really, really good. And I tell you what, if they can just keep their head down, keep their nose to the grind, and keep playing really good baseball and avoid injuries. Obviously, that's the, you know, part of the equation that nobody can predict. You can't coach against it or those are things that just happen. The good thing is East Carolina is as deep this year as they've ever been. So hopefully, if they do have any kind of injuries, it won't slow them up too much.
Be a good week, midweek matchup coming up tomorrow. Pirates have already won a couple against Duke during the midweek, trying to knock off Wilmington, who, by the way, Billy, if you go to ecupirates.com, UNCW, beside their name on the schedule, says RV. Now, we were trying to figure out what that means yesterday. And is Ronald Vincent coaching the game? Are they driving RVs, taking RVs to the game? Turns out that is receiving votes. So I'm not going to get you started, but
oh, geez.
There's an RV beside UNCW's name.
you know, because there's D1 baseball, there's collegiate baseball, there's the USA Today coaches poll.
Don't get me started.
National College Baseball Writers Association. Which one am I missing out? Oh, Perfect Game. That's another one.
Yeah.
What's that, 5 or 6?
Did you even say Baseball America? Maybe you did. I don't know.
That's the one I missed.
Okay. There you go.
There's collegiate baseball. There's Baseball America. There's D1 baseball. There's Perfect Game. There's USA. I mean, it just gets ridiculous. And I would hope that, you know, at least with college football, there's two polls. And we always go by the AP poll. It seems to me like anything that has the attachment coaches poll on it, I question.
Yeah,
because half the time these coaches aren't really voting. It's the SIDs at the school that are putting in the vote. They're like, I don't know, put something down. I don't have time for that.
Which is probably better than, because how many of these coaches are watching these other teams play? They're watching their team and their opponent on film, and that's, you know, pretty much it. Yeah. So,
yeah, because, and that's funny, because usually when you talk to a coach during the season, you ask them about other. I don't know. I just know about our opponent coming up. So how can a coach's poll be that good?
Yeah, that was one of the first things I remember, like, getting into this, Billy, kind of when I was younger, and going out on a Sunday night when ECU would have practice and talking to, like, even Donnie Kirkpatrick, who is a Washington fan, but, like, I'd be like, man, did you see the game today? He's like, no, what happened? Like, I just assumed everybody in football watched every game like I do, but they don't have time because they're doing other stuff.
Right.
They miss, like, the entire season. They watch the playoffs, and that's about it. So, anyway, speaking of football, we got football on Pirate Radio coming up tonight. New Bern taking on D.H. Conley. Conley in a stretch where they're going to play, what, 3 games in 8 days? Played Friday night, got beat by J.H. Rose, which you told me, I'll give you credit, Weave. You told me before the game kicked off that I should not make that bet with Scooter, so I'll give you some credit on that.
That's not a good
one. Conley's got New Bern tonight, and then another game coming up on Saturday, so Nate Connor's guys getting in a lot of football right now.
Yeah, and you know what, it is raining right now, and on a normal day that you have a high school football game around here that is so much rain, obviously the ECU football practice has been pushed back, canceled, postponed, whatever you want to call it, because of the wet stuff. This game, they're gonna play this game. As a matter of fact, Nate Connor said earlier today when he was Tyler Feldman had called over there to, you know, I said, hey, make sure that game's still going on. He said, we're going to play 100%. And the thing is you've only got set when you're in a spring football season, and because of the COVID issues and all that's happened, what has happened now is you've forced these high school football teams to play. They've got to play because there's only 7 games during the entire season. There's no room to be able to postpone or push back games.
Yeah.
They're on the schedule. You got to play them if you can. So that game's going to be played tonight. And, you know, the kids like that. You go out there and you play and slop around in the mud. It'll be a whole lot of fun. You know, it's not the best atmosphere for fans, but obviously we know the situation with fans right now anyway. So that game will be played tonight. And like you said, it's going to be a tough stretch of, you know, 3 games in, what, 8 days for D.H. Conley. So, but they're young. You know, these guys want to get out there and play. And, you know, before you know it, in the blink of an eye, this season's going to be over. So these kids need to get out there and play as much as they can.
Weave, before we let you go, let's talk a little NASCAR. Martin Truex Jr., a winner at Phoenix, and now they're heading back east here. You got Atlanta coming up, and then it'll be the dirt race at Bristol, which I'm starting to see a lot of drivers not too happy about that. I don't think they know exactly that. They're not too sure it's going to be good racing on that dirt track, but we'll talk about that next week. How about Atlanta coming up on Sunday, Weave? Who are a couple of favorites in your eyes?
Well, I do want to say that I'm kind of one of those guys that, you know, I'm looking ahead.
Okay.
Like, Atlanta's a very fast speedway, but I've been excited all year about the dirt race. I know that the drivers aren't, and the reason they're not is because there's so much of the unknown. They have no idea what to expect, so they're a little cautious, a little timid. But we'll talk.
And I think it was Kevin Harvick who said that it's going to be the slowest, you know, racing around a dirt track you'll ever see, or something, just the way the cars are. I don't know. So,
well, because the cars are so big and so heavy,
they
aren't like Sprint Cup cars where they slide them sideways. Usually dirt track racing, it's sideways racing, and they're racing sideways around the track. They've got the throttle down, and they're sliding those things. You can't do that with these big cars,
NASCAR
Cup Series cars. So it is going to be a little bit different, and the guys don't know what to expect, but that's part of why I like it. And if it ends up only being a one-time deal and nobody likes it, and it's like, at least they tried.
They gave it a shot.
Different. And
yeah.
They gave it a shot.
And they'll be back at Bristol for the playoffs later this year anyway on a, you know, the normal track. So, you know, it could be a one and done. Yeah. We'll see. How about Atlanta, Weave? You got a pick for us? You can go Chase Elliott.
I'm going to go Chase Elliott. You know, like I said, with how the situation is with no practice, no qualifying and stuff, you have to go with notes and you have to go with guys that have been successful there and you have to go by the numbers. I think if I was in Vegas, like when I go to gamble, I like to gamble in Vegas on the roulette wheel and I play streaks with odds and evens and you have them on the board where the numbers, the past numbers have come up and it's always done me well. So if you play the streak at Atlanta, in 2017, Brad Keselowski won. In 18, Kevin Harvick won. In 19, Brad Keselowski won. Last year in 20, Kevin Harvick won.
Wow.
So,
okay,
just leads you to believe that if the trend stays the same, it's a lot like a roulette wheel, that Brad Keselowski is going to be the winner coming up this weekend.
I like it.
Now, that's if the streak stays. Now, of course, there's also other guys that perform well. Kurt Busch has won there three times, but he hasn't won since 2010. So that's another guy you got to throw into the mix. And I always, you know, and speaking of the roulette and the gambling thing, you know, trying to pick one driver to win a race every week is extremely hard because it's like picking a winner in a golf match.
Yeah.
You got to, it's not like picking either Washington or Philadelphia.
Yeah.
You know, you got a 50-50 shot. Because there's only two participants. When you've got 40 drivers in the field, trying to pick that one guy to win is hard to do. And it just goes to show you the first, what, five races of the season, there's been different winners each week. So.
Yep, and we'll see if we have a new one coming up on Sunday. Billy, always enjoyed the conversation, man. Have a great rest of your week. And a lot of sports for you guys to cover over at WITN. So I know you're staying busy.
Yes, sir. Tune in tonight and see if your D.H. Conley Vikings could bounce back and beat Newbern after that. I'm not going to say beat down. It is what it is, but they did have a tough loss against Rose.
Should I call Cy Seymour and place a bet real quick? I need a Newbern guy to bet with.
Hey, he's the Newbern guy. There you go. Get a little bit of revenge back.
I know Cy's always going to be optimistic about his team, so he probably would bet me, honestly.
They
All right, Weave. Thanks, man.
He's another Washington football.
Oh, man. I need to get him on and talk about Fitzpatrick, get his thoughts on that. You're right.
There you go.
Later, Billy. Thanks, man.
All right, man.
Billy Weaver joining us. We'll get a break in, come back, and wrap up hour one of Pirate Radio Live. Coming up in hour number two, we will talk to Pitt Community College head baseball coach Tommy Eason. Also, Stephen Igo going to join us in our second hour. Ariel Epstein coming up in hour three. Take a time out, come back, and have more for you on Pirate Radio Live. Back after this.
Find yourself working from home or at least spending more time there? Want some remodeling for your house or a fresh look? How about a new deck or screened-in porch to add livable space outside? Don't know who to call? Well, you do now. Call the professionals at R&R Remodeling. They've been serving the local community for 15 years. Ronnie and his crew can help you today. Call for a free quote, 252-286-4119, or visit R&R Remodeling on Facebook. R&R Remodeling, construction you can count on.
Over 32 years ago, the Ronald McDonald House of Eastern North Carolina opened its doors as a place to help families stay together and close to the care they need when they have a sick child. With the addition of a second Ronald McDonald House inside the Maynard Children's Hospital, our need to serve is greater than ever as the medical community flourishes. Help us expand our mission of keeping families close as we grow to meet that need. You can show your support by making a donation to the Ronald McDonald House. Visit our website today at rmhenc.org for more information. Thank you for your support.
The best place in Greenville to unwind and have fun is AJ McMurphy's.
AJ's is open every day with great food and great drink specials. Plus, you can always watch every game from NCAA hoops, Major League Baseball, NASCAR, and more. Looking for something to do? Stop by AJ's for Open Mic Mondays, Sports Trivia on Wednesdays, Music Bingo on Thursday, and live music every Friday and Saturday with no cover. AJ McMurphy's, Turnberry Square at Bell's Fork, and on Facebook, Instagram, and Snapchat.
In sports, if you think joy only happens after you win, think again. Look at the world's most successful athletes like Serena Williams, Brooks Koepka, and Alex Morgan. They don't spend all their days grinding away. They take time to enjoy themselves, like getting together with friends over a Michelob Ultra, because they know that happiness is the key to winning and that joy is the whole game, not just the end game. Michelob Ultra. 95 calories, 2.6 grams of carbs. It's only worth it if you enjoy it. Enjoy responsibly. AB Michelob Ultra Light Beer, St. Louis, Missouri.
Join us for the first annual North Carolina Strut Masters Championship on Saturday, April 10th. Presented by Crescent Tools. Brought to you by Mountain Dew, Yeti, Sam Jones Barbecue, Spring Hill Outfitters, and Nomad. Compete against some of the best turkey hunters in the country, like Michael Waddell, Hal Schaefer, and Nate Hosey. Live performances by Nate Hosey and much, much more. Registration now open for two-man teams at ncstrutmasters.com. Teams with the top-scoring birds will win big cash prizes, up to $15,000. The tournament is open to residents and non-residents that have access to hunt properties in North Carolina. Deadline to register is March 31st. Weigh-in is at R.A. Woods Farms, 39 Vanderford Thomas Road in Farmville, North Carolina. We'll see you there. BMS Builders is your premier custom builder in Eastern North Carolina. With Blackwood and Mills Creek in Greenville, Dalton's Cove in Farmville, and Belmar in Aiden, these are just a few of the developments featuring BMS Builders homes. They can build the home of your dreams. Just ask Dr. Dennis Ross in Greenville or East Carolina football coach Mike Houston. They built their homes, and they can build yours as well. BMS Builders. Give them a call at 916-1578 for BMS Builders.
The best place for delicious food and great prices is Familia. Familia has something for everyone, like New York-style pizza, lasagna, chicken, veal, or eggplant parmesan, homemade meatballs, plus a variety of seafood selections and favorites, like the steak burger and southern pork chop. If you need food to go, Familia's drive-thru window is open and ready for all takeout orders. Familia, Fire Tower Road near Pitt Community College, and FamiliaNC.com.
This is Coach Donnie Kirkpatrick, offense coordinator for ECU football, and you're listening to Pirate Radio, the voice of the Pirate Nation.
You're listening to Hour One of Pirate Radio Live. This hour is brought to you by University PC Care, your local tech support experts for all your personal and business needs. Visit universitypccare.com to learn more today. Now, back to the show.
Welcome back. Are you in outside sales and looking for an opportunity to increase your earning potential? Coffee Pro has been in Eastern North Carolina for over 45 years and continues to grow each year. And they are in need of more sales professionals with a desire to potentially make a six-figure income. Do you have what it takes? Visit CoffeePro.net today to submit your resume and to learn more. Now let's head back in to Pirate Radio Live. Here's your host, Clip Brock.
All righty, wrapping up hour number one. We take our brackets seriously here at Pirate Radio. In fact, one of our guests yesterday on the program, Ronnie Woodward, you heard him on the show sniffling and sounding stuffed up, had the bad allergy kick going. Maybe the rain washed all the pollen and allergy stuff away, so that's a good thing for some folks. Ronnie busted in a moment ago and grabbed his bracket and said he had some adjustments to make. That was about 4 minutes ago, right when we went to break, and he is still
working on his bracket.
I don't know if he was like feeling bad yesterday and his head is clear now. I think he's got some insight on what's going to happen in the tournament.
Bryce Williams over there?
As a matter of fact, I just want you to know that Bryce, if Bryce is listening, a bracket is headed his way. Jenny took one over to him to make sure.
So by Thursday at 5 o'clock when he joins us, he might be halfway done?
I would hope so.
Okay, all right.
But, I, you know, see, sometimes I think y'all, there are some people that are participating in this that I think are taking it just a tad bit too seriously.
Well, I want to
like,
win.
I fill it out and I just let the cards fall where they may. If it works, great. If it doesn't, it's not going to hurt me. I've got no skin in the game. But there are some folks that are just by their just general demeanor when it comes to filling out these brackets that are taking it way more seriously than I think most folks do.
I want to win it, but like you, Shirley, I fill mine out during a break on yesterday's show. So in less than four minutes, I was done. I don't love it. I've got some things here that I don't really think are going to happen, including St. Bonaventure going to the Elite Eight. But I like it. That's what I'm going to root for, and I'm not going to change anything.
Yeah,
I'm done.
The only thing that I would change is in the event that a team had to bow out and had to be substituted in.
By the way, by the end of today's show, I think the window is 6 o'clock today. If a team's not out, then there's no replacement teams going in.
Okay.
So
all right,
I believe that's the deadline. So then after 6 p.m. today, if a team bows out, then the team they're facing advances.
All right, then.
Via forfeit, I believe.
There you go. So, Ronnie's done.
So Ronnie makes his adjustments, and he's back in. All right.
I think it was Ronnie yesterday talking about how much he loves Bagel Man, so he must really want that $50 gift card to Bagel Man.
He went home and told his wife what the prize was, and she was like, "We need to win this thing. We
need
to win."
She said, "Well, now,
I need
you
to focus.
Focus, Ronnie. Yeah. Focus."
I mean, because look, if you were in a pool where you could win like $10 million, oh yeah, I'd pay real close attention to that kind of thing. But you know, like I say every year, as long as I finish ahead of Troy Dreyfus, I'm good. I don't care if I win or not.
Still trying to find when the years Troy says he's won multiple times.
I don't know because I don't save them. Yeah. I throw them away every year, so I have no idea.
I won the last one. And
the only way we
y'all
know,
gotta beat me. I'm the champion. Me. Me.
The reigning champ.
So that was 2 years ago. Do you remember who it was that won 2 years? Was that Virginia?
Yeah.
Okay. So, all right. Look, like I said, as long as the final stats at the end of the tournament, as long as I am one number higher than Troy Dreyfus, I am good.
All right.
Stat to consider. Shirley is above.
By the way, this whole time change spring forward is overrated. Let's go back to the way it was before. This weather is awful.
Oh, it's terrible. Yesterday
I was told this would be glorious. What's going on?
Like, can't wait to get home after work and be able to kind of sit out in the yard or do something, maybe, you know, cook on the grill. And for the past two nights, yesterday it was overcast and freezing cold. Today it's freezing cold and raining. I don't think it stopped raining all day. It's very annoying. Like, let's get to the sunshine.
Correct me if I'm wrong, but did the weather, forecast change dramatically? Because I swear, I thought I looked at the weather forecast, on Sunday, for the week, and it was showing that it was going to rain today, but it was going to be, in the 60s. I swear I thought I saw that. Wow. And then all of a sudden I saw, Monday 54, Tuesday 44 with rain. And I'm like, wait a minute. How did it go from 60 something to 44?
Apparently today is the outlier, although Friday is showing 62 with a low of 33.
Yeesh.
So, yeah.
Another cold front coming through.
Looks
is it supposed
way.
To rain on Saturday?
It's showing, it doesn't show rain Saturday, 53, 33.
What about Sunday?
It's showing rain today, Thursday, Friday, and that's it. So no rain other than those days.
It was 35 degrees when I left my house this morning.
Can we have last week's weather?
Yeah. You go from 75 degrees.
And run around in shorts to sweatpants
with,
and
a wetsuit.
Yeah. I thought I was going to need a boat to get to my car.
It's North Carolina weather for you, Shirley Rhodes.
Wait 5 minutes, it changes.
Let's take a timeout. We will come back, and baseball coaches don't like to talk about the weather. especially Tommy Eason. He's already had some brutal weather. Yeah, we'll get that out of the way now.
Cliff Godwin definitely doesn't like to talk about the weather.
Although I might bring up the weather when we talk to Tommy Eason. He's the head baseball coach out of Pitt Community College. He'll join us on the other side to kick off Hour 2. We're back with you on Pirate Radio Live after this.
What the heck was that?
That was Chuck again from Naughty Dog. He loves to run around town screaming when there's a new beer release. This week, he's super excited because St. Patrick's Day is on Wednesday, and Naughty Dog is releasing their new Irish Eyes Dry Stout and the Hellcamp Irish Red Ale. Plus, on St. Patrick's Day, there'll be Uncle Fred's food truck, ice cold green beer, and plenty of indoor and outdoor space for everyone to celebrate. Go to Naughty Dog Brewing Company on Main Street in downtown Winterville, and be sure to follow Naughty Dog on Facebook and Instagram.
For the latest from the world of golf, tune in every Saturday morning from 8 to 10 for the Golf Shop Radio Show, presented by GolfKnickers.com, the world's leader in traditional golf apparel. Hosts Mark Greenhalgh and Matt Blanchard talk golf from tee to green and everything in between. If you like golf, you're going to love Golf Shop Radio. Before you tee up, drop on in. Welcome to the Golf Shop.
North Carolina State Parks is proud to announce that they have partnered with the Hometown Strong program. Our visitor centers are now equipped with public Wi-Fi to help kids with school. Remote learning has become a critical public health measure in maintaining social distance and continuing to educate our young people. Take advantage of Wi-Fi and a hike at Goose Creek State Park or a day trip to the beach and access remote learning at Fort Macon State Park. For more information, visit hometownstrong.nc.gov.
Hey Pirate Nation, Big Ed Watkins here. As a former ECU football player, America's gas man, three-time NASCAR champion, and three-time Daytona 500 champion, I know what it takes to win. I also know what it takes to make folks happy on the water. When I'm not at the track, I'm making deals at the hottest boat dealership in North Carolina. If you're in the market for a boat, shop us online now at edwatkinsmarine.com. We will deliver anywhere. And if you buy a boat from me, Pirate Nation, I will personally deliver it. I love Eastern North Carolina, and we are ready to deal with lots of inventory on hand. We are your one-stop shop for sales and service. Get on the water now with the help of Ed Watkins Marine, and go Pirates!
It's bow time. There's something special about the first bite of a Bojangles Cajun Filet Biscuit. Like an edible alarm clock that slaps you awake with bold Cajun flavor. The moment you sink your teeth into that soft, fluffy, made-from-scratch biscuit, then strike gold with a juicy piece of fried chicken, you'll know. Nothing beats the first bite. Except the second first bite. Get a Cajun Filet Biscuit combo for just $4.99. It's bow time.
I'm Michael Vaughn with East Coast Grading and Utilities. Many of you know my dad, David Vaughn, and his work in putting in subdivisions all over Pirate Nation. But East Coast Grading and Utilities is not just for those type of big jobs. We're here for the homeowners. Whether it's concrete, driveways, hauling rock or sand, whatever you need, East Coast Grading and Utilities can get the job done. Call us at 252-531-7494 or check us out on Facebook at East Coast Grading and Utilities.
This tax season, get more in return during Bostic Sub Furniture's Tax Mania. Update your home for less with savings of 15% off throughout the store. Living room, dining room, and bedroom furniture at savings of 15% off. Save up to 70% off clearance items or get 48 months special financing. Now's the time to get a better night's sleep on a Scott Living or Restonic mattress and enjoy 48 months special financing. Your tax dollars go farther during Tax Mania. Now at Bostic Sub Furniture.
This is Pirate Radio WGHB Farmville, W224EI Greenville, WDLX Washington, and W281CH Washington. You're listening to Hour 2 of Pirate Radio Live. Now, back to the show.
Welcome back. From sales to service, Greenville Auto World has all of your vehicle needs covered. Shop all of their inventory now at greenvilleautoworld.net. If you're also looking for someone to service your vehicle, Greenville Auto World has a full service and repair facility. Brakes, oil changes, tires, inspections, and they can repair any kind of vehicle. Greenville Auto World, across from Speedway at Bell's Fork and online at greenvilleautoworld.net. Thanks to Tim Sutton and Jim Rogers of Greenville Auto World for their sponsorship of the program. Now let's head back in to Pirate Radio Live. Here's your host, Clip Rock.
Back with you, hour two of Pirate Radio Live. Stephen Igo, Hoist the Color, is going to join us coming up a little later on this hour. Ariel Epstein, going to talk NCAA tournament with us coming up in hour three of today's show. Right now, we will head out to the Fixed NC Live line. The Pitt Community College Bulldogs are off today, which is a good thing due to the weather outside. Hope to be back in action coming up on Wednesday. And the head coach of the Bulldogs is former Pirate Tommy Eason, who joins us on the Fixed NC Live line. Coach, appreciate your time. How you doing today?
I'm good, Cliff. Thanks for having me, man.
Yes, sir. We last spoke, I believe, last summer when there was nothing going on, and I think you were getting a little stir-crazy, but nice to have baseball back. And, of course, could have got you on a better weather day, Coach, kind of an ugly one today, but you guys have been able to get some baseball in, and I know just generally speaking that's got to put you in a good mood, and all the guys on the team too, right?
Well, yeah. I mean, it's, you know, obviously a long layoff, you know, basically a year, but you know, getting back on the field, and you know, the first couple of weeks of the season were kind of brutal as far as weather wise, and you know, we're starting to see another round of weather come in, and you know, we're supposed to play tomorrow up at Lewisburg. I haven't spoken to their coach yet, but you know, if we had to play here tomorrow, it probably wouldn't happen. But you know, we just hopefully we can, you know, get that game in, but you know, we've got a big weekend against Camp Community College out of Franklin, Virginia, supposedly home on Saturday. And hopefully we can get the tarp on the field tomorrow afternoon late and get it ready for Saturday, Sunday.
A lot of games postponed already this season for Pitt Community College, but we're able to get some baseball in. And Coach, did you notice, generally speaking, rust from your guys without playing, you know, organized baseball? Or were they able to get in enough individual work during the off time, during the hiatus, that they came in and it looked like any other year? How about that?
I don't know if you call it rust. I think, you know, the biggest thing is getting in a rhythm with the team, you know, even with the rain outs and trying to get the pitching staff work on the mound and those types of things was tough. You know, if we couldn't play, if we couldn't practice, and getting live scrimmages in and those types of things were non-existent early in the year. But, you know, coming back from last year to this year, I think, you know, guys are just excited. Maybe if they had some rust, the adrenaline flow kind of knocked that off. But, you know, I feel like we're in a good position. We just, like I said, we need to play and get our pitching staff, you know, some more work and against different competition. You know, I can say this, in the fall we were good at practice because that's all we were able to do other than scrimmages between ourselves. So, you know, playing somebody with a different color uniform on is definitely, you know, definitely important.
And, Coach, how about the recruiting aspect of it without being able to travel and going to see guys play for such a long period of time? What was that like for you? How were you able to get recruiting done? What did you have to do this past year that you hadn't had to do in previous years in recruiting?
Well, we had a lot of guys return, even some guys that had actually graduated. And, you know, now they're some of them dual enrolled in the fall at East Carolina. And, you know, we were fortunate in the fact that we had a lot of returners coming back. The unfortunate thing is this year will be the biggest recruiting year that we've ever had, just simply because we've only got two true freshmen on our team. So, you know, this year is going to be where you have to lean on people that you trust, take their word for it. You know, and, you know, we deal with a small number. You know, 30 is kind of our magic number. And, you know, it looks like we're going to have to bring in 28 new players. So this is going to be the big year for us. Last year for the high school seniors was probably the most unfortunate recruiting aspect. You know, high school seniors last year are the ones that probably, you know, suffered the most. And, you know, this year they got a limited schedule, and hopefully we can get out and do some recruiting you know, that's going to be based on what the high school, you know, it seems like the High School Athletic Association is making even, you know, better provisions than some of the colleges are.
Talking to Tommy Easton on the Fixed NC Live line today. And, Tommy, let's talk about some of the talent on your team. Nice D.H. Conley connection. I like to see that as a former Viking. I've actually had Shea Ward on the show before and talked some baseball with him. And Tommy, every time I look, I see Cam Jackson is really excelling right now at the collegiate level. How about these local kids that you're able to have on the roster and how much success they are providing?
Well, I think, you know, it's a benefit to have those guys, obviously the talent that they have, and, you know, it's beneficial too also because their families can come to games and obviously have some fan support there. But, you know, we've got a good mix. I mean, I think, you know, the Greenville guys and also, you know, some other local talent in Newbern, Vanceboro, Morehead City, you know, places like that. And, you know, it's good to have Eastern North Carolina guys, but, you know, we've got guys from western part of state. You know, we've got a good mix from basically the East Coast. And, you know, the biggest thing, I think, you know, with local guys and, you know, is gelling with the rest of the team because a lot of times, you know, they get, you know, distracted from being a local person. But, you know, the guys on our team have, you know, really gelled together. And like I said, all the guys, you know, seem to be, you know, coming along. You know, Shea's not necessarily struggled. He's hit some balls right at guys. So, his, you know, his average is not, you know, obviously where Cam's is. And, you know, Cam is leading our team and, you know, has done a very good job in the leadoff spot.
Tommy, you talked about your end of recruiting. How about, you know, four-year colleges talking to you and talking to your players without being able to see them play for so long? How different was that this past season? And now that they're able to get back on the field, is that interest kind and communication kind of increasing as we go along?
Well, and you know, I think a lot of the situations, you know, these coaches are going to we've got video. You know, we've had to become techno geeks on, you know, video and
yeah,
things like that. And, you know, we're live streaming games, but even with our live stream, it's a stagnant camera, and it's you know, we're not, you know, moving in on guys and you know, but it's, you know, it's better than nothing. And then, you know, we're videoing our pitchers, you know, basically on a daily basis in games and things like that. So, you know, a lot of it's going to be up to them to kind of reach out to college coaches that or colleges that they have interest in. And then, obviously, the colleges that they promote themselves to, you know, they're going to call me and ask me, you know, my opinion. And, you know, I'm going to be very honest with them, good, bad, or indifferent. You know, that's just the way it's going to have to work.
Tommy Easton joining us on the Fixed NC Live line. Tommy, one thing I noticed over the weekend and just about any time I see – scores and pictures from the game, you got a strong uniform game going over at Pitt Community College. I don't know how important this is to you, but players love it, and we like looking at it. I'm a hat guy, so I like looking at the hats and everything. You got some great uniforms over there, Coach. And again, is that something that you care about necessarily? Is it a necessity to have nice uniforms in 2021? Talk about that.
Well, I mean, we actually bought a new uniform last year and didn't have a chance to really wear it. You know, try to add one, you know, every 2 years or so. You know, it's ironic that you say that. On Sunday, we wore all whites, and that top, and I hate to even say this, but that top was one of the first tops I bought. But
wow,
you know, one of the things that we do is take care of our stuff. And, so, yeah, I think it's, you know, super important, you know. You want to look good. A lot of times, if you feel like you look bad, you play bad. And so the persona of trying to look good, and, you know, we're a clean cut team, and, you know, try to keep that persona. That was something, you know, I continue to do. That Keith always, you know, didn't allow facial hair, and I'm a big proponent for that, just because of, you know, it may be one person that looks at one of our guys, really likes his as a player, but doesn't like the features that he's on the field, you know, earrings and those types of things. So we just try to clean persona, clean look, and, you know, glad you like our uniform.
Tommy Easton joining us on the Fixed NC Live line. Tommy, you mentioned local parents being able to see the kids play. That's a benefit to having local guys. How about fans in general right now? How many people are you able to get out to the field? And obviously you hope that number increases as the season moves along.
Well, right now we're at parents or two family members per player.
Gotcha.
So we're not allowing outside fans from visiting teams, scouts, college coaches, those types of guys obviously can get in. We're doing the protocols just like, you know, most everybody, temperature checks and on a daily basis. And our guys, you know, have been very due diligent. We're fortunate, you know, here in Greenville to have the testing center. And right now we're getting tested once a week. So we're doing our due diligence, and our guys haven't barked at anything we've asked them to do. And it sometimes becomes a pain, but, you know, as long as they're playing baseball, I think they're willing to do about anything.
So, Tommy, are people able to watch games virtually when you guys are playing at home?
Oh, yeah. On our schedule, if you go to just our schedule online, look at the live stream feed.
Okay.
All you got to do is click on it, and it's a, you know, YouTube. It's a YouTube subscriber channel, and just have to have YouTube, and you watch it.
All right. As Tommy said, he's a tech geek, so all you guys are able to watch the games these days. Tommy, good stuff. Thanks for joining us, and hope we can get some good weather in and some good baseball in. Things are taking a turn, a lot more positivity out there, and seems like we're heading in the right direction. Hopefully the weather takes hold of that, too.
Yeah, absolutely, Clip, and I appreciate you having me, man.
Thank you. There's Tommy Eason, Pitt Community College head baseball coach, joining us on the Fixed NC Live line on today's edition of Pirate Radio Live. We will take a time out, come back. Steven Igo joins us. He's going to talk some spring football with Igo. I guess we can still do that, but won't have day one of practice to discuss after that was washed out today. We'll talk ECU football, NFL free agency, Pirate baseball, and find out what Igo is going to do in his 2021 bracket. That is on the way when we return on Pirate Radio Live. We're back with you after this.
Hey Pirate Nation, this is Tom Brown from Brown & Wood Cadillac. We've been serving the Pirate Nation in Eastern North Carolina for 83 years. We have four brands, three generations, two showrooms, and one goal, to make sure you leave a happy customer.
This month at Brown & Wood, get a 2020 Cadillac Escalade and save up to $15,000 off. And as always, Brown & Wood is the home of the Lifetime Powertrain Warranty.
We're located on Greenville Boulevard next to the Convention Center, or shop us online at brownandwoodauto.com.
With rates being historically low, now is the best time to buy or refinance your home. This is Talbot Green with Angel Oak Home Loans. Now is the time to take advantage of the opportunity to buy more home or refinance your current mortgage. The combination of our local team's experience and Angel Oak's wide offerings of products from standard conventional, government, and portfolio loans has something for most financial situations. For more information, call Talbot Green, Joanne Weir, or Wanda Hager at 751-2060.
NMLS 1719250 and 685- 842, Equal Housing Lender.
The convenience of Pitt Greenville Airport is waiting just outside your front door. Service is back, so you're connected to destinations worldwide through flights from American Airlines. Plan your next trip. Book your flights today at flypgv.com or aa.com.
Whether you're flying for business or for pleasure, enjoy the friendly convenience of flying from your local airport to get you where you're going and then home again safely. For your next trip, remember, American Airlines is back at PGV. Book today at AA.com. Pitt Greenville Airport, where the Pirates fly.
This is Martin Truex Jr., and as a NASCAR Cup Series champion, I love one-stop shopping. When I need fresh tires or fuel during a race, my pit crew takes care of everything. Off the track, I have an auto owner's independent agent. They handle all my insurance in one place. Car, home, life, and business. Get your own pit crew and find a local agency with auto owner's insurance.
This is Norm Bryant with Town Insurance in Greenville. Call me today at 756-8300. Go Pirates!
Looking for your next career opportunity? How about some extra cash to help pay for school? Your locally owned and operated Dixon Foods McDonald's is hiring, and they would love to have you as part of the McFamily. They offer flexible hours, competitive pay, and financial support to pursue your education through McDonald's Archways to Opportunity program. Come join the family at McDonald's. Don't let this financial opportunity pass you by. Please visit DixonFoods.com to apply.
If you wake up in the morning with a backache, feeling more tired than you did when you went to bed, you probably need a new mattress. And the best place to get that mattress is Factory Mattress. Hi, I'm Kirk Smith, General Manager. For more than 40 years, Factory Mattress has been Greenville and Wilson's local mattress dealer. We guarantee the lowest price on the area's best selection with over 50 models to choose from. No seconds or overruns. Factory Mattress offers only first quality direct from the manufacturer. Sealy Posturepedic, Beautyrest, Stearns & Foster, and Tempur-Pedic. The most highly trained sales associates with over 60 years of combined experience. Same as cash financing with zero interest up to 48 months and free local delivery. Face it, to have a good day, you've got to have a good night. So sleep better knowing you saved money at Factory Mattress, locally owned on Greenville Boulevard in Greenville, on Forest Hills Road in Wilson, on the web at FactoryMattressUSA.com, and a proud member of Pirates Supporting Pirates.
I can't think of anyone who doesn't love a clean car, but how often do you actually go to the car wash? Does it take too long, or maybe it's just not a very nice place? Tommy's Express changes everything. Our wash is bright, inviting, clean, and fast.
I love the flat conveyor belt. So easy to pull onto, much smoother ride, and safer for my car.
And when you join Tommy Club, you can wash as often as you like for one low monthly price.
I save money and time.
We're Tommy's Express.
Tommy's Express Wash, now open on the corner of Greenville Boulevard and Red Banks Road. In Greenville.
This is East Carolina assistant basketball coach Steve Rockford, and you're listening to Pirate Radio, the voice of the Pirate Nation.
You're listening to Hour 2 of Pirate Radio Live. Now, back to the show.
Welcome back. Have you heard the news? American Airlines is back and has resumed service to Pitt Greenville Airport. Reservations are available now at AA.com. Whether you're flying for business or for pleasure, enjoy the friendly convenience of flying from your local airport to get you where you're going and then back home again safely. For your next trip, remember American Airlines is back at PGV, and you can book today at AA.com. Pitt Greenville Airport, where the Pirates fly. Now let's head back in to Pirate Radio Live. Here's your host, Clip Rock.
Back with you on PRL here on a Tuesday. Ariel Epstein going to join us about an hour from now. Talk tournament, talk props. Games going on tonight. Hornets. Big fourth quarter last night.
Hornets.
To knock off the Sacramento Kings. Gordon Hayward with the throwdown on De'Aaron Fox.
Oh, yeah!
Eric Collins was fired up. Chandler was fired up. I was fired up. And
Bomb of the World!
Hornets right now, Chandler, are they still like a game out of hosting a playoff game in the first round? I think they're a game out of fourth right now.
20-18.
Yeah, playing well.
I think a comfortable lead in our division, I believe. I think our division stinks.
Let's see. Yeah, they
do divisions
are,
matter in the NBA?
Nah. They are a half game back of fourth. Somehow, they're only like 3.5 back of Milwaukee. I mean, they really have played well. Yeah. Exceeded expectations here in 2020, 2021. I guess Nuggets got a win. I was backing them last night.
They're climbing the standings.
They are 23-16 and in fifth place. Again, the West, pretty much Igo's entire life has been better than the East. You got to go back to like the 90s with Jordan and the Bulls, I guess. Yeah. And I don't even know at that point if the West might have been better than the East, but the East had the best team overall. But the West continues to just be miles and miles ahead of the Eastern Conference. Anyway, Igo, I love the Broncos hoodie you're rocking today.
Thanks.
In honor of NFL free agency.
Correct.
Shirley had a Von Miller note, I believe, earlier, right?
Yeah, he had an option. They picked up his option.
Yeah, they exercised his option, so he will play his final year of the contract with the team. It was a heavily debated discussion because he was injured all last year, missed the entire season, was not as productive the year prior, so he's getting paid something like, I think he has a $26 million cap hit or something in that range, which is fourth among all pass rushers. But either way, it was, they tried to get him and take a pay cut. He declined, and they ended up just exercising his option anyway. I mean, new GM, it's tough to come in and basically boot one of the guys who single-handedly won you a Super Bowl just 5 or 6 years ago. So, you know, I have mixed feelings on it. I wish he would have taken somewhat of a pay cut to allow for the team to make some better moves. They still have a lot of cap space left, but also love Von Miller, and I want to see him play out his contract. So, you know, mixed feelings, but I am glad that he will be a Denver Bronco at least one more year.
So did they sign, you're texting me about Darby, Ronald Darby. Did they sign him?
Yeah, they agreed to a 3-year deal with him.
Okay. And no, he's good. I wish he was still on Washington, but he was one of those guys that you're worried, did he play good because it was a contract year?
Right.
So we shall see.
Yeah, I mean, it just feels like all these guys who are getting signed are getting so overpaid, and I guess that's just NFL free agency in general. You have to overpay, and the contracts continue to go up. But I feel like I've seen so many marginal to slightly above average players just cash in with huge contracts, and you know, it's cool, I guess. But you know, I kind of like if my team grows talent and re-signs them better than signing a bunch of free agents.
I feel like if I was a Broncos fan and where that team is right now, I'd be more excited to have Ryan Fitzpatrick than I am as a Washington fan, because he is fun to watch and fun to root for. But like, our defense is ready to make a run in the playoffs, and Fitzpatrick is going to ruin that for us on a lot of occasions.
Yeah, you know, we've talked about it before. He'll make some amazing plays, and he'll probably have like a great comeback game.
Oh yeah,
where they'll come back out from the dead and win. But then he'll probably have three games where he throws a pick in the red zone in a close game. So I don't know, man. That quarterback situation, I mean, how do you even have a competition between Taylor Heineke, Fitzmagic, and the Kyle Allen still there, right?
Because they're all the same? Is that what you're saying? Like, I mean,
well, like, yeah. I mean, I feel like Heineke and Allen are fairly similar, and then you've just got Fitzmagic, who's just the complete wild card.
I think we should implement the starter, reliever, middle reliever, closer type of thing in right. football, because Fitzpatrick's way better off the bench. He sucks as a starter. You got to have somebody start the game and let him come in and save the day. So, I don't know.
It's a weird situation. And then they could still draft a quarterback, too.
Yep, that it could be in the plans. All right, Igo, you were all set to head out and take some pictures, talk to coaches and players today, and have a good old time out of spring football, but the weather says otherwise. So, I guess, what are we going to do, wait another day for spring football practice?
It'll be either Thursday or Friday when they have their first day, from what I've heard. You know, Tom McClellan's email said to be determined as far as what the first day will be. From talking with my sources, it'll be either a Thursday or Friday deal. I think they would like to go Thursday, but there's thunderstorms in the forecast, which makes it tough to plan. Again, ECU not having an indoor practice facility, I'm going to continue to hammer this home until they announce one or do something about it, is just, it's mind-boggling to me that we're in 2021 and there's no, you know, first of all, it should have happened like 15 years ago, that at some point they should have came up with a plan to come up with an indoor practice facility. I looked at across the American Athletic Conference today, and let's see, 9 of the 11 teams have the ability to practice inside, and 7 already have an indoor practice facility. USF is constructing it as we speak. That'll make 8. Tulane has access to the Saints indoor practice facility and the Superdome. Tulsa and ECU are really the only teams that don't have an indoor practice facility.
I know Tulsa's like a small school, small program, but I thought they did have money.
Yeah, you would think so. As far as I read an article that, you know, 2 or 3 years ago, same type of deal. It's time for Tulsa to invest in an indoor facility.
So does Temple use Philly stuff? Or do they've
got
their own?
They've got their own multi-purpose deal, a couple of somewhere in downtown Philly. But it's just, especially Eastern North Carolina, man, and it's not as big of a deal right now because we're in spring ball, but every year during the season, ECU loses at least 3 or 4, a handful of practices where they have to go inside Mindy's, and you just can't do anything. If you want to expect your program to compete for conference championships, then they need the same advantages every other team in the conference they're competing against has. And so at some point, I get it's a tough time financially right now to raise money, but at some point ECU's got to find a way to get an indoor facility or a bubble or something, just so we don't have to continue dealing with this.
And you're losing days you can't get back, because there's a set date for the end of spring ball. There is a spring game, and So if you lose days, you lose days. You
can't. And this really is at the start. Up. You could lose multiple more practices. I mean, it's just a. Yeah, it's a. I still, you know, Ruff used to beat the drum all the time about facilities. Scotty was the same way. I'm sure Mike Houston, you know, he wanted the indoor facility as part of his James Madison extension. He got that in his contract before coming to ECU. So it's wow. important to Coach Houston. It was very important to Scotty Montgomery. It was very important to Ruff McNeil. So you're talking about, and even Skip Holtz advocated for it. So you're talking about a span of more than a decade now where ECU coaches have been advocating for it. Most of the teams in the American that were in Conference USA, you know, either constructed it in the late, you know, leading up to around the 2010 area. I think you had a lot of those buildings going up. And for whatever reason, ECU has just dropped the ball. And to me, it falls a lot on the Confer regime, because instead of building an actual need in an indoor practice facility, they spent all their money that they didn't have on the Taj Mahal of press boxes and suites.
Yep, and we know how that has gone so far. Steve and I go here ready to talk some spring football when that gets underway. So, again, you don't know the first day they're going to practice. Their first scrimmage is scheduled for, what, not this Saturday, but the following Saturday, I believe?
I think it's a couple Saturdays in, actually. I think the first two Saturdays are scheduled to be regular practices.
So no scrimmage till April, then?
I believe so. Okay. I need to double check, but I think I looked at it the other day, and it was 2 weeks of just regular practice. And they might go inside the stadium that second Saturday and do some work there, but they'll have two official scrimmages and then the spring scrimmage.
Wait, Ronnie, you mentioned it yesterday. I brought it up because it kind of hit me when I was talking to Morgan Ayers on Friday. I go that Blake Harrell ready to have a spring football practice for the first time as defensive coordinator. So they showed signs of improvement, playing with a lot of young unknowns in 2020, and I'm expecting that defense to take another step forward in 2021.
Yeah, there are just so many players in the program and coaches in the program. I would say, and I haven't ran the exact numbers, but it's got to be at least like 65% to 70% of the people in the program have not experienced the spring practice at ECU, because the team is that young. You know, I think it's 69 freshmen or either second-year freshmen, redshirt freshmen, or true freshmen on the roster. None of those guys, outside of the early enrollee redshirt freshmen, have experienced the spring practice. You're talking about at least half your roster right there. Then you've got transfers, new coaches, et cetera. So, it's badly needed. You know, Blake Harrell was kind of coaching and installing by the seat of his pants last year. They really didn't have a ton of time to work on the fundamentals. It was more, hey, here's how to line up, here's how to stunt, here's how to do this defensively, here's our blitz package. Now they can really finally slow down and work the fundamentals, grow the guys up that need to be grown up. I mean, there's so many young defensive linemen, a lot of young DBs that just need teaching. And that's what you do in spring ball. You teach one day, you go back and you review film the next day, then you go build on that. I mean, it's really a building process, whereas fall camp is more, yeah, it's fundamentally based, but you're also preparing for a game and a season. In spring practice, you really focus a lot more on yourself.
I go, it seems like we always say, like, we're young, but, I mean, it is true. Chandler brought it up the other day, switching gears to basketball real quick, that, you know, Joe Dooley talked about it, and we always started using the line, ECU basketball needs to get old and stay old. Well, screw that plan.
Yeah.
New plan this offseason, and it's the plan we had two off seasons ago, where we're just going to get real young and get all new players again. Is that what it's looking like?
Yeah, I mean, I think more of a middle ground, but you're going to have a more new players than returners probably. Yeah. But I mean, really, if you watch the team this year, you know, they were pretty old in terms of, you look back at a couple years ago, they brought in 11 new guys, 7 of those were JUCOs. You know, JUCO, they think about it probably a half a season to a season to figure it out, and usually they don't get a ton better after that.
And old necessarily doesn't mean seniors. It means experience. Staying in the program together and having experience. And they brought back all returners last year, basically.
Yeah, and I think they expected those guys to make a leap, and in some areas they did, some areas they didn't. Some areas I don't really know what to make because of the COVID situation. I mean, I feel like ECU was not as bad as it looked down the stretch, but they also were not as good as
they were to start the season.
Yeah, so like to me, they didn't play Temple twice, which they probably would have won one of those games. They didn't play Cincinnati when Cincinnati was struggling.
As long as you don't play Cincinnati in March, you're okay.
Right, exactly. They go to the tournament every year and almost did it again this year. great program. But no, they didn't play a couple of other they didn't play South Florida a second time, which was a winnable game. So look, they would not have finished in the top half of the conference, but they could have had a few more wins if they would have played a normal season. But either way, you watch the games. You look at them versus UCF. UCF, across the board, more athletic, better shooters, better athletes.
Yeah.
And so ECU, they tried a couple years ago to really upgrade the athleticism and shooting. Clearly, they missed on some guys. A lot of their top targets ended up going elsewhere and have had big success, and some of their backup plans haven't worked out so hot. So, to me, I think you got to find a middle ground, but you do have to continue to try and turn over the roster and find a way to upgrade the athleticism and shooting, because clearly you've had this same group for 2 years. You haven't made a ton of progress in the wins and loss column. So, you know, you keep the best of the bunch. You keep Jaden Gardner. You add a few transfers. You add some talented freshmen in a year where probably a lot more teams are going to be focused on the portal than freshmen. So, you know, I do like the freshmen they've added. I like the Boston College transfer, Winston Tabbs, a lot. If you can add him to the returning nucleus and maybe pick up another transfer or two, then I think you can make significant strides. Now, I don't think Joe Dooley, a couple years ago when they brought in 11 new guys, envisioned bringing in even, you know, a seven or eight-man class again, but sometimes you just got to do what you got to do. It's clear that what they did this year didn't work.
He's trying to win.
I mean, the conference is just...
It's a tough league.
It really is. Like, I get tired of saying that. I'm sure everybody gets tired.
It's not... The programs are better than ECU.
Yeah, I mean, that's why it's a tough league.
Yeah.
Because ECU, if you're a recruit and you're being recruited by every team in the American, ECU is near the bottom.
Definitely.
So, I mean, you're trying to basically get more talent than those teams or find a way to get a mix of talent and experience to beat those teams. So how do you do that is the question. And I think they tried a couple years ago, and now you try again. I mean, what else can you do?
All right, just for fun, let's do the 2021-22 starting lineup. If you don't know a name, you can just say new player. If you think it'll be a new player starting, you can say that player. Or, you know, it can be a returner. So starting at point guard for your Pirates, Tremont Robinson-White.
Yeah, I would say Tremont Robinson-White.
Tremont.
TR Dubs.
Starting at shooting guard for the Pirates, Tristan Newton.
Yeah, or Winston Tabbs. I mean, both of them are going to be in the lineup, I would say.
Starting at small forward for the Pirates,
I would say
Newton or Tabbs?
I would say Newton. Newton's 6'5", so he probably starts. You almost have to run a three-guard lineup. Tremont, Tabbs, and Newton.
And starting at the four, Jaden Gardner.
Jaden Gardner.
Starting at center for the Pirates.
Insert new player.
That,
is that one of the options?
Yeah, yeah. No, okay. It is. Is that player already like committed or signed, or is that newer player?
I think the goal is to add a transfer or a big man.
Big man.
They reached out to a kid from Western Michigan already, 6'8", 250. But I think they're going to reach out to a couple more guys. The portal is not done. I mean, you got all these teams in the tournament that are going to have guys entering in the coming weeks. You know, ECU has yet to have anybody enter the portal that we've heard about. So that's only a matter of time. So, I mean, you still have a lot of guys to go.
Just checking to see where Usman Haruna is these days.
I completely forgot that player existed.
I don't know why it hit me, but he is playing for what school am I at again?
Montana State.
Montana State.
I think his career is done, by the way.
Usman. Okay, yeah. He, these bios, it's really short. Inter season and competition for playing time. So, yeah, he had... And that's the ECU numbers. He averaged 1.2 rebounds, 8 minutes.
I forgot Usman Haruna existed. Dean Riak, he finished up his career at Akron. Justin Watley, or was it Whaley?
Yeah, Whatley.
Justin Whatley, former ECU big man. He graduated from North Carolina Central. He is back in the portal.
Wow.
After this season.
Dmitri Spasievich is, everybody gets another year, so he could be back with UMBC next year. Saw him playing in a game this year.
Spaz, I don't know what his numbers were, but I think he was a good fit for UMBC. Like, he was just, the athleticism was too much in the American. He played a game one time, 32 minutes, and didn't get a rebound at 6'8".
Yeah, that's tough, Jeff. Let's take a timeout. We will come back and talk more with Steve and Igo, round out hour number two of today's show. Maybe we'll talk some Pirate baseball coming up. We got to find out what Igo has going on in his bracket. He has admitted that he has not watched a ton of these teams. In fact, he has watched all of or less than 5 minutes of your champion.
Yes.
But you've seen enough.
Oh, I saw plenty.
I like it. That's all it takes, the eyeball test. Ronnie did that with, I think, West Virginia. He said he saw them on a random Saturday, and he's got them going far. Who did Igo see over the weekend that he likes a lot? We'll find out when we return after this.
At Tiebreakers, we admit we have a bit of a problem. People love our wings so much that they're starting to sell their home TVs just so they can watch all the sporting events here at Tiebreakers. Seriously, we're glad you love our hand-bred and hand-cut boneless wings that much, but we really need you to go home at the end of the night. It's okay, we'll be here tomorrow. And when you come back, bring a friend with you. For great food, great friends, and cold beer, we'll see you at Tiebreakers. Tiebreakers, break the chain, eat local.
They say nothing in life is free. Well, we're here to tell you they're wrong. Because when you switch to U.S. Cellular, you can get the Samsung Galaxy S21 5G for free with no hidden requirements. That's right. The Samsung Galaxy S21 5G has launched, and you can get it for free with no hidden requirements. U.S. Cellular. Terms and conditions apply. See store or uscellular.com for details.
Does the idea of going to your local U.S. Cellular store make you feel a bit uncomfortable? Tired of the hassle of waiting and wearing a mask? Let Toby Williams and his outside sales team take away that worry. They will come right to your home or office and drop your phone off on the porch or at the front desk for you. Saving you time and worry is what the team at Cellular Warehouse is all about. Call Toby today at 252-799-7051 and let them help you with all of your wireless needs. Cellular Warehouse, your local U.S. Cellular authorized agent.
Warren's Hot Dog Pizza, homemade lemonade.
Hey, Pirate Nation, Warren's Hot Dogs' two locations are open for business in Greenville and Chocowinity. Both locations have drive-thru windows, so stop by today for hot dogs, pizzas, subs, apple and peach turnovers, homemade lemonade, and breakfast in Chocowinity, featuring homemade cheese, ham, and chicken biscuits, plus sausage dogs and more. Warren's in Greenville, across from Ron Ayers Motorsports, and in Chocowinity next to the fire department. Warren's Hot Dogs. Want some? Get some.
Hey, Eastern North Carolina, this is Miles Menjes.
And this is Landon Menjes with Menjes Bottling Group.
We are proud to announce that Pepsi is once again the official soft drink of the ECU Pirates.
That's right, Miles. Our family's purple and gold roots run deep. From founding members of the Pirate Club, alumni, and even a team physician, our support over the last 60 years has never wavered. We are Pirates.
We're excited to be back at ECU and are honored to serve our great customers throughout Eastern North Carolina. Not only is this the birthplace of Pepsi-Cola, this is our home.
Cheers, Pirate Nation. I like the sound of that. Support local, drink local, stay safe, and drink Pepsi.
Been pulled over for speeding and written a ticket? Then you need to call O'Neill Speedometer Service in Greenville. O'Neill's can calibrate all vehicles for speeding tickets. All-wheel drives, no problem. 18-wheelers, no problem. Motorcycles, no problem. O'Neill's can also repair instrument gauges that have stopped working. Whether you drive a Ford or GMC, Greenville's trusted speedometer shop for over 30 years is O'Neill's. Call today for repairs or calibration work at 756-5050. O'Neill Speedometer Service. Go Pirates!
Hey, Pirate fans, it's time to get your yard done right. With the new John Deere mower from Quality Equipment, our premium lawn care lineup is what every homeowner needs this spring. A John Deere will change the way you mow with easy-to-use attachments, effortless steering, and intuitive controls. Right now, save up to $700 on X300, X500, and X700 series mowers. Learn more at qualityequip.com and get quality done right. Offer ends 3/1/21. Some restrictions apply. See dealer for details.
Ahoy,
way, mateys. To keep those cars clean, you need the Pirate's Cove Fast Pass.
The new Pirate's Cove Car Wash and Haviland Express Lube on Glen Burnie Road in New Bern is now open. Pirate's Cove in New Bern is offering Fast Passes for $9.99 for new Fast Pass customers. You can visit us in Greenville on Fire Tower Road, Memorial Drive, and on East 10th Street. And have you heard? Pirate's Cove on Fire Tower Road is now offering interior cleaning.
So we have you surrounded. Pirate's Cove, the official car wash partner of ECU Athletics.
This is former ECU football player Bryce Williams, and you're listening to Pirate Radio, the voice of the Pirate Nation.
You're listening to Hour 2 of Pirate Radio Live. Now, back to the show.
Welcome back. Did you miss the show on Pirate Radio? Listen to all of Pirate Radio's archived local programming by subscribing to us on Apple Podcasts. Subscribe today by going to the podcast app on your iPhone or Apple device and search for Pirate Radio Audio Archives. Now, let's head back in to Pirate Radio Live. Here is your host, Cliff Rock.
Thank you, Shirley Rhodes, Chandler Honeycutt, Intern Tully here on a Tuesday. Steven Igo is here. We were talking a moment ago about the, just for fun, projected starting lineup for ECU basketball. Team might look a little different, but we'll have some returners. I don't like this topic, Richard, who was chiming in on Facebook Live, asking about Jaden Gardner's return. What is his incentive to return?
His incentive to return is... he's got 2 years left. He could play one more year, get his degree at East Carolina, the school that recruited him.
Finish what he started.
He could finish what he started. He could finish as the school's all-time leading scorer. He could finish potentially as the best player in school history. He's going to be the man here. He knows the league. ECU already has a guard that should come in and open the floor. And Winston Tabbs, who can do a little bit of everything. So, really, for the first time in his career, he will have a proven guard, assuming Tabbs gets here and stays healthy, to kind of complement his game. Certainly, there would be incentives to try and go elsewhere, but the way I look at it is he's the COVID deal, he's got 2 years left. Why not come back to ECU, play your 4 years, get your degree, and at that point, you don't technically owe ECU anything. I mean, you did what you signed here to do. He wants to come back for a fifth year, great. If he wants to move on to the NBA or test the waters elsewhere, I wouldn't blame him. So,
yeah, whatever he decides to do, I'm not going to blame him. Yeah, I mean, anyway, obviously, selfishly, we want him to be a Pirate until his eligibility runs out. If you're a player, you want to win games, you want to go to the NCAA tournament. So, whatever he decides to do,
yeah,
I wish the best for him. I'll root for him. I almost said I'll root for him. I will root for him no matter who he's playing for. I might not root for the team he goes to.
Right.
Because that could end up really bad. But I will always be a Jaden Gardner fan. And he'll be back in the lineup next year, Richard. So
I get the sense he truly loves and appreciates ECU. You know, he's not a guy who feels like he's too good for ECU. Now, there are certainly teams in his ear, and not in his ear directly, but the way it works is they go through his AAU coach or his old high school coach or people that know his family, basically, and they're like, hey, if you enter the portal, we got a spot for you or something like that. Just like ECU probably does to guys who they would do the same for. So that's basketball. That's what basketball has become. So basically, you can get recruited even without being in the portal indirectly. That's how college basketball works. That's how a lot of sports work these days with the portal. But I still feel like he will come back for his fourth year at ECU. I haven't heard anything that he wants to leave. I'm sure he's frustrated. I mean, if you're that good and you've yet to see the wins pile up, that's got to be frustrating. But I get the sense he wants to finish what he started.
All right, coming up at after Pirate Radio Live today, we've got D.H. Conley football. They'll be taking on New Bern. Coming up Wednesday at 6 o'clock, we will air the potty.
We will air the potty?
The Pirate Radio podcast, a.k.a. the potty, P-O-D-D-Y.
Oh, the potty.
The potty. That's just cool shorthand lingo for podcasts that hip people say.
I think that's why people say pod. and not the potty.
You're probably right. You can be said even shorter with, yeah, pod makes more sense. With the new chancellor, Philip Rogers of East Carolina. So
can we talk to finish that and we'll talk about
it. We got that airing Wednesday at 6, but you can download it and also check it out on YouTube. It'll be available. It'll be uploaded. Pirate Radio Podcast brought to you by White Claw Hard Seltzer. Visit whiteclaw.com today. That's Wednesday. Thursday, after Pirate Radio Live, we'll have the first four those games coming your way on the airways. And then Friday, it's all day, wall-to-wall NCAA tournament basketball, which I was about to segue into, but one more aside from IGO before we get there.
Yeah, I was going to say, is it legal to play three high school football games in the span of 8 days? Like, that seems very dangerous.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm all for it.
To answer your question, yeah, it's legal.
I mean,
nobody's going to get arrested tonight.
I'm all for guys getting to play their games and make them up, but man,
yeah,
going Friday, Tuesday, Saturday, that's a lot to ask.
In the spring.
In the spring, and you're asking probably some of your players to play both ways.
Yeah.
I mean, that is, I don't know, that doesn't seem like a great recipe to me.
Look at IGO thinking about the kids. He's got a kid on the way. You're changing your ways.
I mean, even if I didn't have a kid on the way, that just seems kind of not the best idea, but hey.
If you were, you didn't play football at Conley, did you?
No.
You played baseball. You would want to play as many games as possible, though.
Yeah, like, yeah.
You have to.
But you know those dudes are going to wake up Sunday morning after.
Yeah.
If you're playing three games in 8 days, you're going to be sore.
You're going to be feeling it. Conley and New Bern going
out. And I'm sure Rose Conley was a physical game. I mean, it's not like they're playing, you know, little sisters of the poor out there.
And for what the season is this year, I mean, Mark Lindsay, shout out to you. This is a big ball game because New Bern has an L to Rose. Conley has an L to Rose. The loser of this game is going to have two losses in the league. And I go, it's a pretty tough league.
It is a tough league, but they should be able to bounce back, especially after the New Bern game. I don't know. I think they have Washington Saturday.
Good too.
Well, whatever. Either way, my question is, is Mark Lindsay going to be on the Nate Connor post-game Zoom?
What do you leprechauns got cooked up for St. Paddy's Day? Oh, boy. Mark Lindsay, an all-timer. All right. IGO, NCAA tournament coming up. Don't forget, folks. When Thursday gets here.
What do you turkeys got cooked up for Thanksgiving here?
Yeah.
You know, hopefully. Yeah.
You match up against this particular ball club as you come into this week. And, you know, that's a pretty, that could play, you know, at the higher level.
For sure. For sure. Yep.
Blake, where do you feel like you've learned the most about your defense so far? What have they gotten better at, and besides what you just talked about, where they got to get better at?
that one is definitely my favorite.
Oh, better, best.
What do they have to get better at?
Best.
You guys need to play the, you probably can't play on the radio, but I sent you the audio of the American Athletic Conference press conference with Mike Oresko the other day.
Yeah.
And he was talking about Memphis, you know, they deserve to get in. And I guess some Memphis fan got on the call and they didn't mute him, or he was unmuted, and he just kind of blurted in.
And he said, I don't understand what he was complaining about.
So a lot of Memphis fans are upset that they, towards the end of the year, remember they Memphis had a long pause and they lost the Wichita, I think both Wichita games, or at least one of them. They lost
opportunity, and they were kind of right there on that, just outside the bubble.
Basically, and so this person was like, well, if that, he just kind of interrupted Oresko. He's like, oh, well, if that's the case, give us a game.
Bleeping game, yeah.
And Oresko and the AAC communications guy were just so stunned and their faces popped up. And Oresko was just like, Chuck, can you take care of that? Or, let's just go to questions. I don't know. You just have to watch. It was super hilarious.
It was a weird moment.
By the way, where was that American defense on Sunday for Cincinnati?
Well, you know, when you're playing the Houston Cougars in a tough leg, And you're going, what, four games? 3 days? 3 games, 4 days?
Listen, Chandler, Houston had a special season. It was a very special season.
Quate Schmeyer.
What about Cincinnati?
What about a story that Cincinnati was in the tournament, Iga?
They were. They almost extended their NCAA tournament streak to 10.
To 10. That would have been 10.
Which would have been amazing, especially seeing as they just lost one of their key young guys to the transfer portal. Something's not right there with John Brannan. They've lost a couple of four-star recruits this year to the portal. So we'll have to monitor that. But they still have talent. They got top-end talent.
Well, yeah. Last year something wasn't right at Wichita State, and it worked out for them. They are they're in the tournament.
I mean, Isaac Brown, Coach of the Year.
What is the schedule for Thursday? Let's take a look at it real quick.
I don't really care. I don't watch the first four.
All right. Well,
And I'm really bummed out. I was trying to plan, you know, a get-together with some friends to watch some tourney action on Thursday night, and then it's just the first four. So I'm like, no, like, I'm not going to go out of my way to watch the first four.
We'll do it on Friday.
I got to work all weekend.
So Monday.
Yeah, I probably have to work Monday. Like, this whole Friday to Monday thing is not cool.
So the only day you have off is Thursday.
Thursday night is perfect for me.
All right. It's all about you.
And you had to ruin it, NCAA.
So coming up, 5:10, True TV on Thursday, Texas Southern versus Mount St. Mary. 6:27, TBS, Drake, Wichita State. Yeah, look,
I mean, that's a pretty good game, honestly.
Getting together to watch Drake, Wichita State, and UCLA, Michigan State is not a bad, and you can root for App State if you want to. That sounds like a great Thursday.
We got four games here. Why is UCLA and Michigan State tipping off at 9:57?
Because that's when UCLA is playing, and I guess gives the West Coast eyeballs. I don't know.
I mean, I just can't stand those.
You are just a sourpuss.
Why not 8:57? That's 7 o'clock on the West Coast.
I don't know. I don't have the answer, Stephen. I'm not a TV executive. Maybe you should ask Mike Oresco. Look, our tip-off times are growing.
Mike Oresco mentioned Joe Dooley and ECU's growing program at least 3 times.
We're growing. We're getting there, folks. We are Power 6. Stephen,
you're 7.
Who do you have? Let's go through it real quick.
Whole bracket?
First question, no.
Okay.
Biggest first-round upset.
The biggest first-round upset.
I'll tell you mine while you're looking. I got the Gauchos of Santa Barbara. I've got Ohio. Ohio 13 seed is my biggest first-round upset.
I've got Liberty over Oklahoma State because they play that frustrating style. Oklahoma State likes to get up and down. I know they have Cade Cunningham, but I feel like when I've watched Oklahoma State this year, they can be very inconsistent, as can all of these teams.
Except Gonzaga.
Except for Gonzaga.
Who you have in the championship, but losing to
the Fighting Illini of Illinois.
Now, how much basketball, Illinois basketball, have you watched this year?
4 minutes and 35 seconds of overtime as I was waiting for the selection show to come on.
So if that game didn't go to overtime, they would have had the selection show on. You wouldn't even have watched any of it.
I would have picked Loyola to beat Illinois.
I actually did do that. So I have Oklahoma State in the Final Four. You have them losing in the first round.
Yes.
I have Loyola Chicago beating Illinois. You have them winning it all. So a couple of key matchups to watch for our particular brackets there.
You want to get together and watch it?
I got to work all weekend.
So we can just get together in the press box and watch it.
So in the past, we've had tournament games on. You think we'll...
I think so, yeah. I mean, it's just Illinois State versus ECU.
Now, the Bonnies game is going to be ending as I'm announcing starting lineups for ECU on Saturday. So I'm going to have that game on. Hopefully, we have TBS up there. Or TNT, actually.
Yeah, I got St. Bonaventure rolling to the Sweet 16. I got them beating LSU and upsetting Michigan.
I like it.
And so many people are now in on the Bonnies that I'm worried they're going to lose to LSU by like 40.
I've already told everyone, if you get mad because you took the Bonnies because I talk about them, that's on you. That's not on me. Don't be mad at me when LSU beats them by 15. That's your problem, not mine.
But when they win,
then I'm taking all the credit, and you can thank me by giving me a piece of your bracket winnings. So there you go.
But yeah, I looked at Illinois stats. They're averaging 81 points a game. They're shooting 38% from three. They got a 7-footer who's
dominant. Kofi.
They got a 6'5" guard who's dominant.
What's Kofi's name?
Coburn, you told me.
Kofi Coburn.
Spelled Cockburn.
Spelled Cockburn, yeah. So he could be a player to watch.
I mean, he's 7'7", 285.
Yeah.
And he's averaging 18 and 9.5 a game. So
the big fella. All right, let's take a timeout. We'll come back. Hour three of Pirate Radio Live. Igo going to hang out another segment here with us. We got a booty bag to give away, a prize to give away. And Ariel Epstein later on this hour as well. It's all ahead on PRL on a Tuesday. Back with you after this.
What the heck was that?
That was Chuck again from Naughty Dog. He loves to run around town screaming when there's a new beer release. This week, he's super excited because St. Patrick's Day is on Wednesday, and Naughty Dog is releasing their new Irish Eyes Dry Stout and the Hellcamp Irish Red Ale. Plus, on St. Patrick's Day, there'll be Uncle Fred's food truck, ice cold green beer, and plenty of indoor and outdoor space for everyone to celebrate. Go to Naughty Dog Brewing Company on Main Street in downtown Winterville, and be sure to follow Naughty Dog on Facebook and Instagram.
You demand perfection. That's why you drive the perfect car. Okay, maybe it's not exactly perfect, but it's perfect to get you to Domino's for their perfect $7.99 carryout deal. Carry out any three-topping pizza or a 10-piece order of wings, smothered in delicious sauces like hot buffalo, garlic parmesan, and honey barbecue, just $7.99 each. Demand the perfect carryout deal at Domino's. Carryout only. You must ask for this limited time offer. Prices, participation, and charges may vary. Excludes XL and specialty pizzas. Crust availability varies by size.
Your future is yours to create, and with the leadership development of Army ROTC, you're capable of taking command of it. Even in the midst of a pandemic, enrolling in Army ROTC prepares you to thrive as a full-time college student. Our specialized elective courses will equip you with the skills necessary to succeed in life, all while earning money for education. A strong future takes a strong force. Find out how to lead at goarmy.com/ECU. To learn more, contact Dale Anderson at 252-622-5346 or Anderson D. at ecu.edu.
If you are push mowing your yard using an inefficient lawn tractor or your current zero turn spends more time in the shop than mowing your grass, it's time you look at a Hustler zero turn lawnmower. Residential mowers from Hustler are built like tanks and drive like sports cars. All Hustler mowers have fabricated welded steel decks. Don't settle on cheap units with flimsy stamped decks from big box stores. Come see Ron Ayers Motorsports and we'll guide you to the right mower for your property and your budget. Find us at Ron Ayers Motorsports, Highway 11 North of the airport in Greenville.
In studio today with Tony Edwards from AG Home Solutions. Tony, tell us about your business.
So the name of our company is named after me, Anthony Gene Edwards, and that's where we get most of the questions from. Where did AGs come from? We are a fully licensed commercial and residential remodeling company, and we're based out of Washington. We have a showroom with a design center. I have a second general contractor that works in my office with us. Her name is Kathy Herring, and we'll be glad to come out and take a look at any properties you want to renovate, remodel, or additions you may want to do.
What sort of projects do you guys do for folks, and what distinguishes you from your competition?
So we do a lot of historical properties, and probably one of the biggest things that separates us is we're very innovative. We can figure out how to use small spaces to make larger spaces. Folks are more remodeling and staying at their homes instead of selling and buying new homes and bigger homes. So we can take older homes and bring them up to date with open concept.
What's the best way for people to contact you?
252-947-2526. And our website is agshomesolutions.com.
Been pulled over for speeding and written a ticket? Then you need to call O'Neill Speedometer Service in Greenville. O'Neill's can calibrate all vehicles for speeding tickets. All-wheel drives, no problem. 18-wheelers, no problem. Motorcycles, no problem. O'Neill's can also repair instrument gauges that have stopped working. Whether you drive a Ford or GMC, Greenville's trusted speedometer shop for over 30 years is O'Neill's. Call today for repairs or calibration work at 756-5050. O'Neill Speedometer Service. Go Pirates.
Hey, Troy, have you heard about the place?
No, Jason. What place?
It's The Place. It's Washington's newest restaurant on the waterfront. The place is located in downtown Washington in the Harbor District with waterfront seating in the back. We're open for bistro-style lunches Tuesday through Saturday from 11 to 2 and elevated comfort-style dinners Thursday through Saturday 5 to 9. Plus, Sundays, we have the best southern brunch in town.
Man, that's awesome, Jason. The Place sounds like the place to be.
It is. We look forward to seeing you there. The Place in Washington, North Carolina.
This is Pirate Radio, WGHB Farmville, 1250, and 92.7 FM Greenville, WDLX Washington, 930, and 104.1 FM Washington. You're listening to Hour 3 of Pirate Radio Live. Now, back to the show.
Welcome back. When your AC or your heater needs repair or replacing, call on the reliable service professionals of Delcor Heating, Cooling, and Plumbing. Go to DelcorInc.com or give them a call at 252-321-8868. Delcor, the service professionals in Greenville. Now, let's head back in to Pirate Radio Live. Here's your host, Clip Rock.
All right, welcome in. Pirate Radio Live on a Tuesday. We got NFL news.
Always in the headlines.
Uh-oh.
The Bears got their guy, the new quarterback of the Chicago Bears.
They are who we thought they were.
The Heat Miser himself, Andy Dalton.
Oh, my God. They got the Red Rifle?
Yes. The Red Rifle is heading to the Windy City.
It could be a total goat rodeo.
I love it because
who's our quarterback?
It makes me feel better as a Washington fan that we have Ryan Fitzpatrick, honestly.
Congratulations.
Like that move just went up in my book. We'll get the thoughts of Troy D coming up Thursday on the show, or Wednesday
on the show. That move just feels a lot less painful after hearing that.
I wonder now where does Mitchell go? Let's keep this quarterback carousel going.
Washington football team.
No, no. What did I say yesterday, Chandler, on the show? I said, I'm ignoring this. I didn't even tweet about it. Like, I was not even acknowledging any thoughts that Mitchell Trubisky might go to Washington. It was not even, wasn't even going to play along with it and have a gag about it. But now where does he go?
I've got a bad feeling that it's going to be the Denver Broncos.
Could be.
I feel like all these quarterbacks are just exchanging crappy teams.
Yeah.
And one of the few teams left that has not signed a quarterback to compete with Drew Lock or whatever their situation is Denver.
And have they come out and said Drew Lock's our guy 100%? No. Like, do you still expect them to bring in a QB?
They said they want to bring in competition, or at least alluded to it. Now, they could do that in a draft, but I would assume they would at least sign somebody with some experience.
Well, they missed out on a good one. I go, my guy Tyrod Taylor is going to the Houston Texans. A perfect tank quarterback to have right now.
Yeah, I'm not sad about missing on Tyrod. I wouldn't have minded Andy Dalton. I mean, he's not terrible. Again, we've had this conversation before. Like, these guys are not going to come in and lead your teams a Super Bowl. So it's kind of just like, who can we get in here to run the show?
That's why I said Fitzpatrick would be great for you.
Yeah.
It's like, it would be fun.
It'd be entertaining.
Yeah.
If nothing else, he wouldn't win a Super Bowl. So to me, all these guys are about the same. I mean, they're not going to like make a difference to where the Broncos are going to win a Super Bowl because they signed Andy Dalton versus Mitch Trubisky. But
oh, man. Another one of my guys, real quick, Chandler. My ex-boyfriend. Sometimes still boyfriend, Marvin Jones. Marvin Jones. I had a big time affair with Marvin Jones.
Marvin Jones. He was the most inconsistent fantasy football player.
He is the Ryan Fitzpatrick of receivers.
Yeah.
Has incredible games, makes great plays, never been to the playoffs or won anything in his life, but he goes to a crap team in the Jaguars. But Trevor Lawrence, deep to Marvin Jones. Get ready for the fantasy hookup. What were you going to say?
The Texans have a great quarterback in case Deshaun Watson exits. His name is Tyrod Taylor. He just signed a one-year deal with the Houston Texans for $12.5 million.
Are you serious?
That he's a good quarterback?
Are you serious about any of that?
No, he's actually just signed with
right.
The, did you? Tech. That was a
and
joke.
You've been looking at me as if you were listening to the show. Like, we discussed that in pretty good detail.
Oh, really?
About two and a half minutes ago.
Oh, man.
In fact, you might have been.
I was zoned out waiting for you to just stop
you
talking.
You were reading the tweet as we were discussing it.
Right. Yeah. You were, like, trying to chime in. Not. You weren't going to interrupt, but I kind of heard your mic on. As we were talking about Tyrod Taylor, to tell us that Tyrod Taylor had signed with Houston.
Wow.
I'm a dork.
I'm an idiot. And I will go ahead and admit that I'm an idiot for the signing of Andy Dalton.
Well, they could still get Russell Wilson.
We'll see.
But you were all in on Bears getting Russell Wilson.
Yeah.
Andy Dalton, we need to remake your Jim Rome video, Chandler. Can you imagine the Bears signing Andy Dalton?
Could you imagine wanting Russell Wilson and you get Andy Dalton? Hilarious.
That is the life of a Bears fan. And in case you missed it, Tyrod Taylor signs with the Texans.
Who did he sign with, Chandler?
I believe team in Texas.
Shirley, okay. Has that reached your news desk yet? Is that...
Why, no.
Okay.
No, it hasn't.
You know, if it does, let me know.
Look, I will let you know.
This has happened so many times where I have announced things literally minutes after it was broke on
that
the show.
That was pretty sudden. Like,
But it's all because I'm so focused in on, all right, I see this, and I'm like, okay, I need to. Like,
this will be a good show topic.
Chandler's like, this is my moment to break some news.
Well, I had the perfect line, like, well, the Texans have a great quarterback in case Deshaun Watson leaves.
At first, I thought you were joking, and then I realized you were serious. I'm like, man, we just talked about that.
I was not paying attention like I usually was in school, not paying attention.
You know what? I am a huge NFL fan. I like to think I know about the league I go, but NFL free agency reminds me that I don't know over half the players in the NFL. Like, when it comes to, like, these linemen and defensive players that are getting these big contracts that teams are excited about, I'm sitting here like, who are these guys?
Well, again, it's like most of these guys aren't elite. They are above average players that are just hitting free agency at the right time. So a lot of them are probably playing out their rookie contract.
Yeah.
So they're in their fourth or fifth year or fifth year in the league. And so, like, you kind of know them, but you don't really know them unless you follow football super closely, and they're not elite, but they're good and they're not great. So a lot of those guys fall into that category, and they get paid huge money, and the Jaguars are trading and signing everybody.
The Chandler, is Saints defensive lineman Malcolm Brown any good? Wasn't that the name of the DB?
Yeah, it was.
They had the interception. Yeah, you don't know. Like, no, he got traded to the Jaguars. Is that a big deal? I don't know.
I have no idea.
Yeah, I don't
know. It's amazing the amount of retweets and likes like Adam Schefter and all those guys get as soon as as soon as it happens.
Do have some breaking news from Chad.
Yeah.
Former Chargers quarterback Tyrod Taylor has reached an agreement on a 1-year, $12.5 million deal with the Houston Texans. Thank you, Chad, for that. By the way, last time we saw Tyrod Taylor, he was getting stabbed by his doctor.
How is he going to play after that, honestly? I mean, how do you, like, come
did
back
did they not
that?
Give him millions of dollars for that?
I would hope so.
Yeah, like, if there's any
some sort of settlement,
100% stone cold, I'm going to win this lawsuit, it would be that one.
Where he was set to be the starter, right?
He was going
to
start that game.
He was going to start that game. He like went on the field and started having problems, and they took him off the field, and it turns out
I forgot that was
his lung got punctured.
Yeah, it was right before the game.
It literally happened, almost before the first snap.
What if that happened to Tom Brady or Aaron Rodgers? Like, it would be
someone
the biggest
would go missing.
Yeah, that it'd be the biggest story ever in sports.
He'd be swimming with the fishes.
I mean, incredible, man. All right, so
the most incredible part of all this is that free agency doesn't even start until like tomorrow at 4 p.m. Right?
Yeah, that's a good point.
But yet, all these deals are being verbally agreed upon, and I guess we'll all become official tomorrow. So, like, the teams can't announce anything.
Right, right, right.
It's all just Adam Schefter.
Sources. All that stuff. All right, I go. ECU baseball, are you going to Wilmington tomorrow?
I'm not.
Now, Ronnie is not going, not because of the travel, not because he has like plans or anything. He's not going because last time he went, the world changed and everything stopped, and he doesn't want that to happen again. I found that to be an interesting reason not to return.
Yeah.
Now, I mean, what is your reasoning?
That went through my mind. That's not the reason I'm not going, because I would like to go, but mainly just the drive. And this year, we're not really getting any different access on the road,
right,
from what I've heard. So, like, you know, it's not really worth going, because I don't think we get one-on-one interviews after the game. Maybe that'll change or has changed, but last I heard. So it's not really worth driving two and a half hours to Wilmington and then back when we can just watch it or listen to Corey Glore or do whatever. So, you know, the Juju thing is weird. It's got to be weird for both teams playing this game around the same time as everything got shut down last year. It's got to be a little freaky. I would like to go because I think ECU-UNCW is one of the best baseball rivalries ECU has. I mean, everybody talks about State and Carolina, but...
And their RV.
Yep, they are receiving votes. But UNCW-ECU brings out the best in both teams. And so it's always a passionate game.
Who was the player we had on that said he hated the Seahawks? It was Brickhouse or Packard? I can't remember, but for whatever reason, like, it wasn't a conference team or anything.
Well, a lot of ECU players say they hate hitting there, because
maybe that was it. Yeah, what's it about the park?
I don't know if it's the batter's eye or what. It's just something. They have this gigantic batter's eye with the Seahawk logo in the middle of it. And I don't know. It is weird. It always feels like ECU is just a tick off offensively there. Now, they find a way to grind out wins there a lot. But we'll see what happens tomorrow night. You know, it should be an interesting game. UNCW is off to a very good start and is a regional caliber team.
All right. And, man, I go the I'll say it again. The defense that they play is almost worth the price of admission alone. Like, even if you didn't get to see him hit or see Wisenhunt strike out 10 guys, watching Giles, watching Agnos, and what they've done defensively this year has been awesome.
Yeah, the defensive play has been outstanding, especially on the left side of the infield. I mean, those two guys are like vacuums. You know, Giles made an error the other day, but it was almost because the runner was going and he tried to make I think too quick of a play. But I mean, Agnos that took a weird hop.
Oh, Giles, shortstop. Yeah.
But you know, just the amount of runs they save, you just don't realize it.
Yeah, exactly.
Because like, you just don't think about that stuff until the ball gets down the line or gets past the shortstop. You almost kind of take it for granted if they're always scooping it up and making a play. I mean, there's so many plays that Giles makes up the middle or in the hole that would be base hits against
teams. On the opposite side of where he's supposed to be.
And Norby as well. Like, Norby, as good as he's hit, he's made a ton of plays up the middle. The one area that I want to see them get better at defensively is first base. I feel like they have not scooped as many balls at first this year as compared to past years. But, I mean, everywhere else on the field, Seth Cadell's come a long way at catcher since his freshman year. I think they are plus defenders everywhere. You know, first base, I want to see them scoop the ball more, which is why you see them make defensive changes late in games. They'll go from Moylan to Francisco and then sometimes even Brooks for defense. So they'll rotate three different first basemen because they have to continue to get better at scooping the ball there.
They'll do that in the outfield too. Riley Johnson, late game defensive replacement for Makarevich, I guess.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, Makarevich, I think, slides over, and then Francisco will go to first. So, yeah.
10-4.
Yeah. But they've got pieces here and there. But the defense overall, definitely stellar. I wrote an article about it today.
Who is starting tomorrow, Iga?
I don't know. I haven't checked Twitter or anything in a while, but I have not heard a starting pitcher for tomorrow.
Scott says the Fitzgerald as bad as the Case Keenum deal.
I don't know. I think
I like Fitzgerald a little more than Fitzpatrick.
Yeah, who's Fitzgerald?
He's got me saying it. He means Fitzpatrick.
Larry Fitzgerald?
Larry, who is still in the league, by the way. I don't think he retired. Case Keenum did play in a playoff game with the Vikings, right?
The year that he signed with Denver, the previous season he had the Vikings in the NFC Championship.
And we got Keenum after Denver.
It was that miraculous play with Stephon Diggs.
That was Keenum?
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Yeah. So,
and then they got smoked whoever they played in the championship. Philadelphia.
Yeah. He's got more playoff experience than Ryan Fitzpatrick.
That's, a lot of people do.
That is true. Because he has zero.
He's never even been on the bench.
Now, maybe so. But maybe as a starter. Huh?
I was just going to say maybe he's got a lot of playoff experience.
He has zero playoff experience. He's not played in a game.
If you're there, technically that's playoff experience. But I'm just messing
with you. I went to a Hurricanes playoff game. Does that mean I have Stanley Cup playoff experience?
As a fan, yes.
Yeah, but...
I mean,
but Ryan Fitzpatrick did the same thing I did. He watched the game and had good seats.
He was involved in the game planning. He knew that if something happened, he would have had to go in. He had to be game ready. You were just there as a spectator.
Oh, I was ready, though.
So you could have been the emergency goalie.
I don't know. I can't skate.
I mean, you just got to sit there.
Have you ever been ice skating?
No, I can't skate either.
Can you roller skate?
No.
I can't either. We've talked about this on the show. I was the kid at Sports World that would not skate, but just play video games.
Yeah, would stand on the side and just watch everybody.
It was very embarrassing.
I think I tried it two or three times and left with bruises and never tried again.
Oh, I definitely tried, and I just looked like a fool, and I didn't really have the patience to figure out to practice.
I remember the teacher being like announcing that we were going to the skating rink. In school, and everybody would get so hype. Oh, let's go! And I'm in the corner, like wanting to cry. Like I don't want to go.
We're all in the no skate club.
Yeah,
maybe we're the cool kids playing pinball and Street Fighter. All right,
y'all are talking about skating.
Yeah, you can probably skate really good, right?
No.
Yeah! All right.
You're talking about roller skating, right?
Right.
Yeah. No, I was terrible at skating. I could get myself going. But I could only, like, you know how...
Well, you got to be able to stop, too. That's a big part of it.
Okay, well, first of all, once you get going, you know how you're supposed to put one foot out, can kind of push one foot this way, push the other foot this way.
I never really got started.
Yeah, I could only do one foot. And especially if I'm going around a curve, I just kind of... It's really bad. My form is really bad. But to stop... You know that lip?
Yeah, yeah.
I hit the lip and I fall over. That's how I stop.
Yeah, whenever I got the guts to go out on the floor, I would like hang onto the railing on the side the whole time while other people were just frolicking like alongside. Frolicking.
People are speed skating past you. They're dancing. Like, yeah, they're doing it backwards. Oh, yeah.
It's time for the couple skate.
Oh, no. We're getting off the floor. Okay. Off the floor. I'm going to go play Pac-Man now.
Hey, any of you girls want to play Mortal Kombat?
Yeah.
No? Okay.
Anybody up for a game for foosball?
Yeah. No.
Pool. All right. Let's do pool.
All you losers out there skating, didn't hang with the cool kids in the arcade or at the...
Or in line for that crappy pizza.
Eating food. Yeah, terrible food. All right. Thanks, Steve.
Thank you.
Bye. Take a time out. Come back. Ariel Epstein will join us. We will talk tournament. See if she's got some props for us tonight in NBA action and more when we return on Pirate Radio Live on a Tuesday. Put your name on your bracket, Steven. Shirley's not going to grade it unless there's a name on it.
I do not award points to someone I don't know whose bracket it is.
We're back with you after this.
See Brian Bailey.
Hey Pirate Nation, this is Tom Brown from Brown & Wood Buick GMC Truck. We've been serving the Pirate Nation in Eastern North Carolina for 83 years. We have four brands, three generations, two showrooms, and one goal, to make sure you leave a happy customer.
This month at Brown & Wood, get a 2020 Buick Enclave and save up to $11,000 off. And as always, Brown & Wood is the home of the Lifetime Powertrain Warranty.
We're located on Greenville Boulevard next to the Convention Center, or shop us online at brownandwoodauto.com.
Wait up, wait up. Papa John's has a new stuffed crust. Oh, we did it. We did it. All our tweets, DMs, and carrier pigeons worked. This ain't just stuffed crust. This is Papa John's crust. Stuffed.
Hey, Pirate fans, order the new Epic Stuffed Crust One-Topping Pizza for only $12. The new Epic Stuffed Crust Pizza is the MVP move for game day or any day. Place your order online at PapaJohns.com and sign up for Papa Rewards. Papa John's, the official pizza of the ECU Pirates.
UBE and PirateWear.com are proud to offer the Pirate Nation its largest inventory ever. Brand new Adidas is arriving daily, along with Under Armour, Columbia, and Russell Athletic. UBE is loaded with cargo, and new items are being added daily to PirateWear.com. Be sure to check out our children's store, The Crow's Nest, for all of your young pirates. UBE and PirateWear.com, an ECU tradition for 50 years. Go Pirates!
The Rick House is Eastern North Carolina's premier American-styled restaurant and bar. Join us at the Rick House for mouth-watering steaks and the best burgers around. Check out the spicy mahi risotto or the bourbon pecan salmon. Wednesday night is date night. Two salads, an appetizer, a bottle of wine, two entrees, and a dessert for just $55. Thursday is ladies night with $5 martinis and special apps. The Rick House, American Provisions and Spirits, 710 Red Banks Road beside the bowling alley in Greenville. The Rick House.
In studio today with Tony Edwards from AG Home Solutions. Tony, tell us about your business.
So the name of our company is named after me, Anthony Gene Edwards, and that's where we get most of the questions from. Where did AGs come from? We are a fully licensed commercial and residential remodeling company, and we're based out of Washington. We have a showroom with a design center. I have a second general contractor that works in my office with us. Her name is Kathy Herring, and we'll be glad to come out and take a look at any properties you want to renovate, remodel, or additions you may want to do.
What sort of projects do you guys do for folks, and what distinguishes you from your competition?
So we do a lot of historical properties, and probably one of the biggest things that separates us is we're very innovative. We can figure out how to use small spaces to make larger spaces. Folks are more remodeling and staying at their homes instead of selling and buying new homes and bigger homes. So we can take older homes and bring them up to date with the open concept.
What's the best way for people to contact you?
252-947-2526. And our website is agshomesolutions.com.
Did you know time spent outdoors can help improve your children's health and bring balance to their life? The Outdoor Heritage Advisory Council invites you to join the PATCH program. This program is for any child under the age of 16 and includes activities like fishing, hunting, and hiking. These are just one of the many ways you can earn the exclusive patches from the Outdoor Heritage Council. For more information on how to sign up and get your adventure started, visit outdoorheritage.nc.gov.
In sports, if you think joy only happens after you win, think again. Look at the world's most successful athletes like Serena Williams, Brooks Koepka, and Alex Morgan. They don't spend all their days grinding away. They take time to enjoy themselves, like getting together with friends over a Michelob Ultra, because they know that happiness is the key to winning, and that joy is the whole game, not just the end game. Michelob Ultra. 95 calories, 2.6 grams of carbs. It's only worth it if you enjoy it. Enjoy responsibly. AB Michelob Ultra Light Beer, St. Louis, Missouri.
Hey everybody, this is David Glenn, and you're listening to my favorite station in Eastern North Carolina, Pirate Radio, the voice of the Pirate Nation.
You're listening to Hour 3 of Pirate Radio Live. Now, back to the show.
Welcome back. At Angel Oak, they continue to make customer service a number one priority. A local mortgage advisor is the key to your transaction success. The combination of their local team's experience and Angel Oak's wide offering of products from standard conventional, government, and portfolio loans has something for every financial situation. For more information, call Talbot Green, Joanne Weir, or Wanda Hager at 751-2060. Now let's head back in to Pirate Radio Live. Here's your host, Clip Rock.
Alrighty, back with you on Pirate Radio Live here on a Tuesday. Going to hook up with Ariel Epstein in just a moment on the Fixed NC Live line and talk some March Madness. Chad is really trying to sell me on Ryan Fitzpatrick for some reason. He's played for almost every team. That has to say something about his experience. It also says that no team wants to keep him if he's played for every team. Why is that? I don't know. I'm not sold on him. Let's see what Ariel Epstein thinks about the move as she joins us now on the Fixed NC Live line. Ariel, how are you today?
I'm good, Cliff. Thanks for having me on.
Thank you for joining us, and we'll talk some NCAA tournament and also We'll ask the prop queen what she likes tonight in the NBA. But how about my Washington football team adding Ryan Fitzpatrick last night, Ariel? And, you know, on that note, we'll throw in some other quarterback moves we've seen today. Andy Dalton to the Bears, Tyrod Taylor to the Texans. None of these really earth-shattering. But what do you think of the quarterback moves that we've seen over the last 24 hours?
Pointless. I'm actually disappointed in your Washington football team. I hope that they do something better than go for Ryan Fitzpatrick. Your Washington football team has been my favorite team to watch in the futures market. You take a look at that NFC East, the worst division in football. Washington ended up going from around 6-1 to win the division. The odds have now moved for Washington to go 3-1. That really has nothing to do with Ryan Fitzpatrick. Yet, I was telling people, once Washington had the worst odds to win the division right as the division odds came out, you have to jump on Washington at 6-1. It's going to move when Washington makes a move for a quarterback. The fact that the line has already moved and Washington hasn't gone for a star quarterback yet, I think it's showing that, Cliff, your Washington football team, if they get somebody legitimate, those odds are going to get the Washington football team very close to the Cowboys to win the division.
Yeah, I don't know. I just don't think he's the guy for this team when you look at a defense that's ready to make the playoffs right now. And they did last year. Defense carried him. Fitzpatrick is such a risk taker. He's going to make mistakes. He's going to turn the ball over, put the defense on the field more than they need to be. I just don't like it.
I want them to do something better.
Please, I'm with you. All right, Ariel, let's talk about what you got going on with the NCAA tournament now. When I don't remember seeing a favorite, and I don't know what Gonzaga is right now. I think it was like minus or plus 150 maybe last time I saw it, as far as them to win the NCAA tournament. That's about the lowest number I can recall to bet on a future for the NCAA tournament. So how about you, if you're looking for somebody outside of Gonzaga, Ariel, to win with a little bit of a better payoff, do you have any teams in mind that you've looked at?
Yeah, I would take a look at Illinois. They're 6-1 currently. It's the second best odds on the board. Obviously, it's not something crazy. You missed a lot of value early, even though Gonzaga hasn't really had much value the entire season. I look at Illinois because I'm thinking back to all the past tournaments, and there's really only been, I don't know, like 5 or 6 tournaments where you've seen someone outside of top 3 seeding win it all. I won't get too crazy. We haven't seen anything crazy happen this year in sports. You think of everyone who's won a championship, it's been the favorite. Even Tampa Bay, you can deem, okay, it's Tom Brady. Every team that's won a Super Bowl, an NHL, the Stanley Cup, World Series, it's been a team that's really been the favorite. I'm looking this year, I can't see anything different happening. I would be very shocked if this year we see someone outside a top 3 seed end up winning. I would go to Illinois. They ended up being the team that, without their best player, potentially the best player in all of college basketball, Ayo Dosunmu, he was out for about 3 or 4 games with a broken nose. Illinois still won their games without him. Now Illinois has their best player again going through the tournament. I think that Illinois is a team that a lot of other teams in this tournament should be keeping an eye on.
Talking to Ariel Epstein on the Fixed NC Live line. By the way, I watched Arrival on Roku TV last week, Ariel, and it's a pretty good movie. First time I've seen it. And I was like, while I'm here, I haven't looked at Roku TV in a while and looked at the listings and saw Sports Grid. And I was like, wait, I recognize that. And flipped over there, and I didn't see Ariel live, but I did see Ariel in a commercial there. So folks with Roku can watch Ariel Epstein on their televisions, right?
Yeah, Roku, Sling TV, Zumo, Pluto TV, SiriusXM, we are all over.
That's awesome, and it was cool to see you, Ariel, and you're doing big things right now. Back to the tournament, you love to look at line movement, especially in football, and we talk about that during football seasons with you. Have you noticed any line movement, and it's only been out a day and a half, I guess, right now, the lines for these tournament games, but have any games moved, any points here, Ariel, that you've noticed?
Oh, for sure. The big one has been Ohio versus Virginia. Hmm. Virginia, remember, dealing with all their COVID issues, they went from minus 10 to now minus 7.5 on the FanDuel Sportsbook, or even minus 8 in some places.
Wow.
I like Ohio, too. They averaged the 17th most points per game in all of college basketball. It neutralizes the tough Virginia defense. If they can at least put up some points, Ohio, against Virginia's defense, then I think that you could see Ohio at least cover this spread. The line's also moving in your favor. I also have seen a bunch of line movements on the Tar Heels. I know people would like to see that. North Carolina, it's moved against them, minus 2 to minus 1.5. Remember, UNC finished the year strong, yet they're the second youngest team in all of college basketball. Wisconsin has some of the best senior leadership in college basketball. I think leadership on Wisconsin, in addition to the inconsistency that we've seen on the North Carolina side, is the reason that you're seeing some of that line movement from North Carolina minus 2 to minus 1.5 against them. Another game that I think has some value that I've seen some line movement on, Liberty and Oklahoma State. Oklahoma State's going to be one of the most publicly bet teams. They have one of the best players in college basketball in Cunningham. So I think that you can see from this line movement, Oklahoma State minus 9.5 to minus 7.5, that there is a little bit of value backing the 13 seed Liberty. Just to cover the spread, not saying anything about an outright crazy win, Liberty's won 12 straight games. They allow just under 60 points per game, which is the third best in the country behind Loyola Chicago and Houston. You could see Liberty potentially putting up a fight against Oklahoma State in a game where the Lions move 2 points against them.
Interesting stuff. Ariel, a lot of the fun of March Madness is the upsets, the surprises, and that's why it's fun filling out a bracket and trying to pick some of those. And I took Ohio. That is the biggest upset I have in the first round. I also have a couple of 12s and UC Santa Barbara and Winthrop, kind of trendy probably. But what do you like on your personal bracket, Ariel, as far as upsets go? And I am in a bracket challenge with you, so I will not use this information against you. This is just for our listeners today.
That's true. I forgot that you're in the Just the Clip challenge. It's going to be very competitive. I actually do have to fill that out. I completely forgot.
I have to as well. I have not done it yet, so I need to do that.
Zach will be mad if we don't. The upsets that I do like, I like St. Bonaventure over LSU. St. Bonaventure is a very balanced team, top 40 in offensive adjusted efficiency, top 20 in defensive adjusted efficiency. LSU's defense is not even inside the top 100. They also struggle defensively from two-point range, allowing opponents to shoot just over 51% from the field. I could see St. Bonaventure upsetting LSU. I also like the 10-seed Rutgers to upset the number 7-seed Clemson. KenPom, which is one of those analytical websites that I use to handicap college basketball, KenPom has Rutgers winning this game by 2 points. It's also interesting because Clemson is the higher seed as the 7th seed, yet Rutgers opened on all of the sports books as either a pick'em or minus 1 favoring Rutgers. Rutgers top 100 in 2-point percentage, averaging 52% from the field. And Clemson, I mean, they struggle. They rank close to 200 in shooting percentage, shooting about 49%. Rutgers also doesn't turn the ball over. They rank 3rd in the country in non-steal turnover percentage. Clemson ranks 137. Rutgers doesn't turn the ball over, and the sports books think that Rutgers is the better team despite the seeding.
Ariel Epstein with some great info joining us today here on the Fixed NC Live Line. Ariel, you like the value of Illinois. Steven Igo was just here. I have his bracket right here. He took Illinois to win it all. Who are you riding with in the Final Four and to win it all this year? Who is anybody outside of the norm for you, or are you sticking with the higher seeds?
Ah, you're killing me. I spend every day filling out another little few games of the bracket.
Okay.
I sat down and filled out the whole thing. I'm just going a little piece by piece.
Interesting.
I will say that Purdue is a team I'm keeping my eye on. I have a friend who is very big into covering the Big Ten. He feels that Purdue is a really good team to keep your eye on who's outside the top 3 seeding. In fact, really believes Purdue has a shot of making the Final Four. I actually will say that Purdue could upset Baylor in the Sweet 16 and make Purdue advance to the Elite 8. You could even see Purdue being one of those outside the top 3 seeding teams to make the Final Four. I have my eye there, and then I also have my eye on this East bracket, where I think FSU has a good shot of upsetting Michigan. Michigan now losing their senior Isaiah Livers, who's going to be out for the rest of the season, most likely with a right foot injury. I think that that's a huge loss for Michigan. I could see Michigan being the first one seed that's upset early on in the bracket. Maybe not too early, not weekend one, but in weekend two, I could see Michigan ending up losing and either FSU, Texas, or Alabama advancing out of the East. I'm still trying to figure out which one. I am the most confident in Gonzaga and Illinois, at least being two of your four Final Four teams.
Ariel Epstein joining us on the Fixed NC Live Line. Ariel, before we let you go, got to ask you about the NBA slate tonight. And speaking of which, you should really like my Charlotte Hornets, because as far as a betting team goes, they are great to bet on this year. They have been fantastic. Won another one, covered another one last night. Tonight, the Celtics and the Jazz in Boston. That'll be a good one. Speaking of good teams to bet on, the Jazz, although I think they maybe have tailed off a little bit against the spread, but they were awesome the first half of the season. Also, the all of a sudden fun New York Knicks are taking on the 76ers. Pelicans Blazers should be fun. So that's the matchups. Ariel, I know you're the prop queen, so you're probably looking at props more than the matchups tonight. So you got anything for us, for me and the audience today that you're liking tonight?
Yeah, the prop that I like the most, and take it a little bit easy on betting it because it has to do with an injury, Bam Adebayo. Actually, Northside Pinetown represent out there in ENC. Bam Adebayo has been dealing with left knee tendonitis, yet he's probable for tonight's game for the Heat. I like Bam to have over 9.5 rebounds. It's not too pricey. It was at -102. I even saw it hit +100 at one point. Bam's hit this number of over 9.5 rebounds in 9 of his last 11 games, in addition to Cleveland giving up a ton of boards recently. Cleveland has allowed for all of the top 10 rebounders that Cleveland's faced in those 16 games. So they've faced a top 10 rebounder in 16 games. 11 of those 16 games have had one of those leading rebounders go over 9.5 boards. Bam Adebayo is a dominant on the board. Cleveland can't match up with them size-wise. I think Bam is going to have a good rebounding night as long as he stays healthy on the floor. Another prop I was trying to look for, yet not sure if he's going to play, Atlanta Hawks taking on the Houston Rockets. Clip, I have done nothing but fade the Houston Rockets on the board all season. So I'm going to say that Atlanta center, if he plays, Clint Capella, he's been dealing with a left heel injury. If he plays, I would take a Capella over on his rebound prop. Houston has no size. They cannot match up with the number one rebounder in the NBA.
Great research done and some great selections there from Ariel Epstein joining us on the Fixed NC Live Line. Ariel, best thing for people to do to start with, give Ariel a follow on Twitter at Ariel Epstein. And Ariel, how can folks find all of your work? Because you're so many places. So tell us what to do.
Definitely all over Twitter and Instagram at Ari Epps, Twitter at Ariel Epstein. Also all over the Sports Grid platforms. You could tune in to SiriusXM channel 204. We are also, as Clip mentioned earlier, on Sling TV, Pluto, Zumo, and Roku TV, all of those streaming services, or just simply sportsgrid.com.
Ariel, thank you so much. Good luck on your brackets this year, and we will talk to you again soon.
Thank you, Clip, and kind of good luck to you, just not in our tournament.
There you go. I feel the same way. Ariel Epstein joining us today on the program. You remember Ariel, formerly of WCTI 12, now doing it big, and great to talk with Ariel. She really does love the prop action, and got some insight there on some rebounding totals tonight for a couple of players. All right, we need to make somebody a winner right about now.
Booty, 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 booty everywhere. Booty, 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 booty everywhere.
All right, 317-1250 is how you win. That is the number to call. Shirley, what are we giving away?
We are going to give away lunch for two at Tiebreakers.
And
I'm going to go with caller number 10.
Caller number 10, 317-1250. You can be a winner and enjoy some awesome food at Tiebreakers. We'll be back after this.
For the latest from the world of golf,
Tune in every Saturday morning from 8 to 10 for the Golf Shop Radio Show, presented by GolfKnickers.com, the world's leader in traditional golf apparel. Hosts Mark Greenhalgh and Matt Blanchard talk golf from tee to green and everything in between. If you like golf, you're going to love Golf Shop Radio. Before you tee up, drop on in. Welcome to the Golf Shop.
There's no better time to drive away with a quality pre-owned car, truck, or SUV from Greenville Auto World. Greenville Auto World is your authorized Rough Country dealer. We specialize in lift and leveling kits, along with custom wheel packages. Whether you're looking for ground clearance or enhancing the appearance of your vehicle, trust our team for your off-road experience. Greenville Auto World, 3840 South Charles Boulevard, across from Hardee's at Bell's Fork, or online at greenvilleautoworld.net.
Hey, Eastern North Carolina, this is Miles Menjes.
And this is Landon Menjes with Menjes Bottling Group.
We are proud to announce that Pepsi is once again the official soft drink of the ECU Pirates.
That's right, Miles. Our family's purple and gold roots run deep. From founding members of the Pirate Club, alumni, and even a team physician, our support over the last 60 years has never wavered. We are Pirates.
We're excited to be back at ECU and are honored to serve our great customers throughout Eastern North Carolina. Not only is this the birthplace of Pepsi-Cola, this is our home.
Cheers, Pirate Nation. I like the sound of that. Support local, drink local, stay safe, and drink Pepsi.
Every team knows that two-point play can be a winning move. That's why I'm here. State Farm agent Timothy Sawyer and my team are here to help you go for two by combining your home and auto insurance. It's a great call that saves you time and money. So go for the win and score some savings by combining your home and auto. It's just another way we're here to help life go right. Call me, Timothy Sawyer, at 493-0002 today.
On Jersey Mike's Day of Giving, we're giving all our sales to charities. Order a sub on Wednesday, March 31st to support a great cause and get free delivery with our app. Jersey Mike's, be a sub above. If you can make a difference, you should. At Jersey Mike's, it's this simple philosophy that spurs us to celebrate our month of giving. This March, enjoy a sub and donate to a great local cause. Jersey Mike's, be a sub above.
Close your eyes and follow me, where the gentle breezes blow. A taste of old Mexico at Chico's. Sunny and bright, like fiesta day and night. Ooh, what a tropical delight. A taste of old Mexico at Chico's. A frosty peanut colada, a toasty cheese enchilada. Oh, you just gotta go where the friendly business goes. Sunny and bright, but fiesta day and night. Ooh, what a tropical delight. A taste of old Mexico at Chico.
Are you trying to reduce clutter? Want to save a tree? Greenville Utilities can help. E-bill is a simple solution. Imagine getting an email letting you know your bill is ready. And with a few clicks on your computer or smartphone, you can review and pay your bill. It's just that easy. Signing up is simple. All you need to do is to log on to your account at guc.com and update your contact information and e-bill setting. You can even continue to receive a paper bill if you'd like. E-bill from Greenville Utilities. Just one of the ways GUC is here for you.
This is Coach Blake Carroll, defense coordinator for East Carolina football, and you're listening to Pirate Radio, the voice of the Pirate Nation.
You're listening to Hour 3 of Pirate Radio Live. Now, back to the show.
Welcome back. Quality Equipment is your full-service John Deere dealer with 28 locations to serve you. Quality Equipment is open in Winterville next to Sam's Club, or visit qualityequip.com to find the location near you. And congratulations to Richard Alto of Greenville. Picked up lunch for two at Tiebreakers. Tiebreakers is open every day at 11 a.m. and is the best place to watch your favorite sports while enjoying the best wings in town, along with sandwiches, appetizers, cold beer, and more. Follow Tiebreakers on Facebook and Instagram for daily updates. Now let's head back in to Pirate Radio Live. Here's your host, Let rock.
All right. Congratulations, Richard. He and his son, Shane, big Pirate Radio listeners over the years. Shirley and Chandler, I haven't discussed your brackets much. Grab your brackets. I'm going to talk about them. Coming up Wednesday on the show, we'll break them down with Mac McCarthy. Coach Mac going to join us on Pirate Radio Live. Also, the big man on campus, one more time to go over some lines before Thursday and Friday's games. Tony Dunn will be in. No show Friday, so we're going to bump Tony up to Wednesday and recap all the free agency news and notes. Excuse me. And we don't have much Panthers to talk about, I don't think, right now, but might have some news on Curtis Samuel by this time tomorrow.
I think we'll have plenty to talk about because I don't think he is a big fan of the signings that we've had in the
So from that standpoint, we will have a lot to talk about. Okay.
I think a lot of displeasure from Tony Dunn coming up on Thursday.
Good stuff. We'll do that. No, Wednesday. Coming up tomorrow.
Excuse me, yes.
And also on Wednesday, Troy D and DG, David Glenn, coming up on Pirate Radio Live and Troy D's reaction to the Andy Dalton to the Bears news. All right, Shirley, what upsets do you have in the first round, if any?
Let's see. Let me just quickly go down here. I think I had one over here on the right side of the bracket. Where was it?
Chandler.
Yeah, let him go.
I have VCU beating Oregon, VCU a 10 seed over Oregon, which is a 7 seed.
Being upset. Atlantic 10 pride.
St. Bonaventure over LSU, even though that's just one seed off.
Not an upset.
Yeah.
I have Georgetown taking Colorado.
As do I.
I'm looking forward to that game. Again, I kind of got swept up in the Hoya paranoia over the weekend. I do have Colorado winning, but looking forward to that one.
I have Maryland taking UConn.
I have Rick Pitino and Iona beating Alabama. No, I'm just kidding.
Oh, okay.
I do have Maryland beating UConn.
Okay.
And I have VCU, which is a 7-10 matchup, but I have VCU beating Oregon.
All right.
I don't really have a whole lot. Usually, you know, I pick one or two teams that I think is going to be a big upset. I did not do that this year.
I got a few. Nothing too outlandish, but again, I do have the Bonnies making a long run. I have Oklahoma State in the Final Four. Let's do that real quick. So who do you have in the West in the Final Four? Everybody got the Zags?
I have Iowa.
Wow. Shirley?
I have, for my Final Four in the West, it's Virginia and Alabama. Or no, excuse me, in the West is Virginia. Sorry. Okay.
I do have Gonzaga in the Elite Eight with Iowa, but I have Iowa beating Gonzaga advancing to the Final Four.
Interesting. All right. In the East, I have Texas. Chandler, I think you do as well.
Hook 'em.
Shirley.
Alabama.
All right. In the South, I have Ohio State. Chandler.
I have the Bears of Baylor.
Okay.
I also have Baylor.
And in the Midwest, I have Oklahoma State.
Oh, you're a big Cade Cunningham fan.
I am. I want to see him take over the tournament.
I'm a big Kelvin Sampson fan. I have the Houston Cougars.
All right.
I have Oklahoma State.
All right, Shirley. Jumping on board with me. I like that one. I have Ohio State and Gonzaga meeting in the championship. What do y'all have?
I have Virginia and Baylor.
You like Virginia to make another run here, Chandler?
I have Baylor as well, Shirley, and I have the Iowa Hawkeyes.
You like Garza?
I love Luka Garza.
You're a Garza fan. And I have Gonzaga finally doing it this year with Mark Few, cutting down the nets and becoming the national champion.
I have Baylor cutting down the nets.
The Bears.
I have Iowa winning it all, and Luka Garza going to win the player of the year.
Luka Garza's number has already been retired at the school he currently plays for, and now it's going to be retired in March Madness glory.
Absolutely.
With the championship. All right, let's take our final break. We'll come back. We'll wrap up today's edition of Pirate Radio Live when we return on this Tuesday. Back with you after this.
White Claw Hard Seltzer, a wave of refreshment. Crafted using our unique brew-pure process. Made pure. Nothing tastes like White Claw Hard Seltzer.
White Claw Hard Seltzer, available in 5 fruit flavors, 2 grams of carbs, gluten-free, and 100 calories. Find it at WhiteClaw.com. White Claw Hard Seltzer, nothing tastes quite like it. Proudly distributed by Coastal Beverage. Please drink responsibly.
You've worked hard to start your business and are working even harder to make it successful. That's when it's most important to have a community bank and a local banker in your corner. This is Eric Clark from Select Bank and Trust. Our team of local bankers care about you, our customer, and the communities in which we all live and serve together. As the business and economic conditions of 2020 threw you many curveballs, our team at Select Bank and Trust remains steadfast in being responsive to your ever-changing needs. In 2021, choose Select Bank and Trust. Bank local, bank select, member FDIC.
I can't think of anyone who doesn't love a clean car, but how often do you actually go to the car wash? Does it take too long, or maybe it's just not a very nice place? Tommy's Express changes everything. Our wash is bright, inviting, clean, and fast.
I love the flat conveyor belt. So easy to pull onto, much smoother ride, and safer for my car.
And when you join Tommy Club, you can wash as often as you like for one low monthly price.
I save money and time.
We're Tommy's Express.
Tommy's Express Wash, now open on the corner of Greenville Boulevard and Red Banks Road. In Greenville. Find yourself working from home or at least spending more time there? Want some remodeling for your house or a fresh look? How about a new deck or screened-in porch to add livable space outside? Don't know who to call? Well, you do now. Call the professionals at R&R Remodeling. They've been serving the local community for 15 years. Ronnie and his crew can help you today. Call for a free quote, 252-286-4119, or visit R&R Remodeling on Facebook. R&R Remodeling, construction you can count on.
Hey Pirate Nation, this is Sam Jones, and we're opening here to serve you with some of the best whole hog barbecue, chicken, turkey, ribs, and homemade sides every day for lunch and dinner. There are 3 easy ways to enjoy Sam Jones barbecue. Swing by our drive-thru window or try one of our 2 curbside takeout options by calling in your order at 689-6997 or ordering online at samjonesbbq.com. We love Eastern North Carolina, and we invite you to come by and enjoy some great-tasting Sam Jones barbecue today.
For years, Callie Ann Phelps has been singing about Phelps Chevrolet.
Phelps Chevrolet is the one for you. Low, low prices, service too. See the big dealer right away. Carolina's finest, Phelps Chevrolet.
And you'll agree with what Skylar Phelps has to say.
Nobody beats Phelps Chevrolet's prices. Nobody.
The name you can depend on. Chevrolet.
Get you one.
Find new roads with Chevrolet. Then come find yours at Phelps Chevrolet in Greenville.
This tax season, get more in return during Bostic Sub Furniture's Tax Mania. Update your home for less with savings of 15% off throughout the store. Living room, dining room, and bedroom furniture at savings of 15% off. Save up to 70% off clearance items or get 48 months special financing. Now's the time to get a better night's sleep on a Scott Living or Restonic mattress and enjoy 48 months special financing. Your tax dollars go farther during Tax Mania. Now at Bostic Sub Furniture.
Let us help you get back to business.
This is Donald Stocks
and Justin Judge of PIP of Eastern North Carolina.
We're ready to assist your business with branded PPE. Would you like face masks with your logo?
We can do that.
Plus custom social distancing signage.
Now is the time to ramp up your marketing efforts. Whether it's cutting edge, contactless, touchless marketing, or traditional direct mail, we can do it all.
We are PIP of Eastern North Carolina.
Hi, this is Phil Steele of Phil Steele's College Football Preview Magazine, and you're listening to Pirate Radio, the voice of Pirate Nation.
You're listening to Hour 3 of Pirate Radio Live. Now, back to the show.
Welcome back. Take a look at your stock market report for today. The Dow was down 127 points at 32,825. The NASDAQ is up 11 at 13,471. And the S&P slipped 6 points and closed at 3,962. That's your Wells Fargo Advisors Financial Report. For a personal look into investing, call Wells Fargo Advisors today at 756-6900 in Greenville. Wells Fargo Advisors LLC, member SIPC. Now let's head back in to Pirate Radio Live. Here's your host, Cliff Rock.
All right. Thank you for tuning in to today's edition of PRO. Once again, the Pirate Radio podcast brought to you by White Claw Hard Seltzer with Troy D and Chancellor Philip Rogers is available for download now. So get it where you get your podcast. The Apple Podcasts. It will be airing on Pirate Radio's airwaves Wednesday at 6 o'clock. We got Conley football coming up in about 30 minutes here on Pirate Radio as they will take on the New Bern Bears. For Shirley Rhodes, Chandler Honeycutt, I am Cliff Brock. We'll see you Wednesday, 3 o'clock, on an all-new edition of Pirate Radio Live. So long, everybody.
Thanks for listening to Pirate Radio Live, an exclusive presentation of the voice of the Pirate Nation. This is Pirate Radio, WGHB Farmville, 1250 and 92.7 FM Greenville.